absolute twaddle. Absolute rubbish.
When all that was gone.
Oh, yeah. Don't talk shit, Carl.
So, anyway, it's going to be...
So oh, Carl, you're talking so much shit again! So you must know that's not true. There's no way.
You're talking rubbish again.
This is such shit!
What are you talking about?
Oh, Christ!
Right, calm down. We haven't got much time left.
Oh, God! What do you mean they said it?
Forget it.
No, don't forget it! Carl, do not press
Switch the record off. Switch the
America for the on the Enterprise. It was all about space, and there was one. There was one question. Answer three, right? And it was who was the first one into space? Yuri Gagarin. Who was doing that? And then the third question was how much bigger than the moon is the sun? Is it twice as big or four times as big? And this one went four times as big. Went correct. It's not. It's hundreds of times bigger. I can't believe. Couldn't someone look that up on the internet? How many times bigger is the sun than the moon? It's not four times. It's huge. It's like beach ball to a pea type dimensions.
Which DJ was it, do you remember, on Virgin?
I can't remember, but it was the one on sort of about 11 o'clock.
Oh,
wouldn't want to be him, right? Yeah, he's embarrassed himself, isn't he? When we do quizzes, we never get anything wrong.
That's true enough.
During that track, I'm chilling out, I'm loving it, aren't I? Carl goes, do you know how baguettes came about?
Do you know how baguettes come about?
I went, go on, and Steve went, no, save it.
Wait a minute, though, I'm thinking, Rick. People are going to be desperate to know the answer to that. Why don't we play some ads and some music and stuff?
It's like a cliffhanger.
Exactly. How did baguettes come about?
Whatever he says is going
to
be good.
Stay
isn't
tuned
it?
To XFM to find out.
Hives. Hate to say I told you so. So I love that sort of stuff.
Mm.
That and the Strokes. So much better than this new metal rubbish, isn't it?
Definitely.
Now, most people think we talk rubbish on air.
Yep.
If they could hear the conversations
off
that
air.
Go on, I know. But someone just emailed in saying the sun is indeed about 400 times bigger than the moon. Thanks for that. That DJ must have looked it up and said 400 times. That can't be right. It's probably probably a printing error. Four times. Yeah. Nothing can be 400 times bigger than the moon. Carl went, yeah, but the sun, it's only got a million years, isn't it? I went, what? He went, on that space program, it said that in a million years, the sun will be destroyed. And he said, and then we're all shafted. Right? I went, I laughed. Steve went, no, it's okay. By then, we'll be on another planet.
No, I think that's true. We'll have colonized
right?
other planets.
Carl went, yeah, but there'll be no sun. Steve went, well, there's other suns, which is true. Carl went, well, I went, well, yeah, every star is a sun. Carl went, well, not really. Not really. Don't believe that, do you? And I went, no, it is. The sun is just a star. It's not even a particularly big star. Carl went, well, why didn't they say that instead of worrying me? Instead of worrying me.
In a million years' time. Yeah. I love that being Carl. He's been preserved, brought back to life, and is now the ruler of the world.
Just a head in a fish tank. And he speaks like this. I am Pilkington.
the reason you became king of the universe, of course, is because of your fascinating French bread anecdote.
Oh yeah, yeah. What come was on the story? Then. What? How did baguettes come about? If this is going to be someone cooked a loaf a bit wrong and said, oh, "I can still make a sandwich out of it," I'm going to hit you.
No.
Go on then.
Right, Napoleon, when he was at war on that with Russia.
Uh-huh.
1812,
Yeah, all his soldiers were like, you know, not used to the cold weather and that. So they said, take some clothes in your bag with you, because it's going to be, nippy out there. So, they put all the clothes in the bag.
Sure.
Did what they were told. Thought, oh, it's Napoleon, for Christ's sake.
No room for any food.
You're joking.
So,
couldn't they make some sort of, like, sandwich?
No, it wouldn't fit, because I've got all the clothes, you have to take extra gear.
Sure, sure.
So, anyway, he said,
I can see
I
where this is going. I'll be honest.
Is there a baguette-shaped gap left in their holdall?
They thought, let's make some bread that you can fit down your trouser leg.
What?
That's not true! No, it's not, Carl!
I read it in Newston train station, I was waiting to go back to Manchester.
Where did you read
it? Scrawled on the wall in graffiti?
Yeah. Was it also, meet me here for cock fun at 12 o'clock?
The upper cross sandwich shop, Newston station, it's on the wall.
What do you mean it's on the wall?
Do you know it says, like, sail on at Dixon's, whatever?
Yeah.
Next to that, there was, like, a bit of information. Once you've read the stuff on Dixon's...
Baguette information.
There was a big thing about the history of the baguette. I read it, and I thought, ah.
we got to make a sandwich we can spit down our trouser leg.
But how can you march and fight with a huge piece of bread down your trouser?
Although, it would be intimidating. You see them coming, you go, sacre bleu, look at the size of them. They're big fellas.
Well, blimey. I can't help but feel that could be a practical joke at your expense.
Yeah.
You wouldn't do that.
Well, the Earl of Sandwich.
Do you ever question anything you read? If it's printed up, is that, like, fact for you then?
Well, it's not funny. I mean, if they were trying to be funny, it's like, it's not, is it? So it's information.
Have you heard us? Things sometimes want to be funny when they're not.
That's exactly what happened with the sandwich. The Earl of Sandwich wanted something he could fit down his pants. And, it was those triangle cut sandwiches wrapped in cling film were perfect. You might be right. You might be right.
I am.
Because the Cornish pasty is so they could drop it down the mines, isn't it?
Is it?
They wrapped it up in an atheist, we don't believe in ghosts, anything like that, anything supernatural. We're followers of James Randi, a genius of our times, but Carl saw something that proved us wrong. I'd like Carl to tell you what this proof was, what he saw it on, and look at him. Go on then.
It was on Wednesday night.
Yeah.
I was watching. You see, the problem is I didn't get the full story, so you could pick holes out of it.
Sure.
Unlike your usual investigations into the supernatural,
which are
it was called. Can I just tell you what the program was called?
Mr. Exorcist.
Oh, brilliant!
So
sounds like an academic work to me.
The bit that I caught, I just flicked it over, sort of seeing what's on the telly, and I thought, oh, Exorcist, I've seen it, but there's nothing else, and I watch it, and then I realised it wasn't the same thing. Yeah. Oh, I'll have a bit of this, and there was an old woman. And a daughter, and as far as I was aware, the bit I picked up on, they were saying, oh, you know, it's dreadful, and unless you've been through it, you know, you've had ghosts in your house and that, you really don't know what it's like.
Yeah, sure.
And the main thing that seemed to be getting them down was the fact that the budgie was getting stressed.
The budgie was getting stressed?
Because animals can sense the other side, can't they?
Can they?
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
And how was that manifesting itself? You don't know. What was the budgie doing?
I think it just wasn't happy.
Right. did it explain that to people, or
no,
how did
know,
it express
I mean,
that?
Budgies are known for being chirpy, aren't they?
I see, and it wasn't chirpy.
It normally swings on its little perch and that. And
just depressed, because it was possessed.
It was just sat around in its pyjamas.
So
No. Come on, Steve. You're making this a mockery. So the budgie was depressed because he could sense the ghost.
This guy, this Mr. Exorcist, came round.
Was that his name?
Yeah.
Okay. Was he a priest or something?
Yeah, he might have been.
Yeah.
Like I picked
up. Did he have a black coat with a little white collar? That's usually the.
He had his coat on, so you couldn't tell.
No, I'm sure. Okay.
But so he came round and he sort of did his thing, and then
was he trying? Was he trying to exorcise the budgie?
No, the ghost. House.
Right.
The house,
so it wasn't that the budgie had a demon or anything.
No. Okay. No, this wasn't a possession, was it? This was a straightforward. It wasn't a poltergeist or anything. It was just a.
Well, it's a haunted house.
Yeah
but sure. that's the thing he was saying you can have, like, your ghouls and that aren't that bad, that aren't going to cause you any problems.
But obviously
the budgie, they've got weak hearts and that, haven't they?
Sure.
Anyway, basically, he sorted it out, did whatever he did, and the next shot you see is, like, the budgie making a noise and swinging
his eyes
over the moon again, and the old woman was, like, happy, because she
couldn't believe
stressed.
It, yeah.
And that's
The priest didn't come in and go, well, you should feed that bird. Give it a bit of millet. It was happy. It goes, right.
No,
see you later. No. It was a. So
I mean, budgies are. My mum's got a budgie. And they're fairly happy all the time, aren't they? So it's got to be something fairly odd.
Right. You never see a budgie sitting down going, I feel like topping myself, to be honest.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean, though?
No.
Do you know you can have, like, a moody dog? You can see a dog when it's unhappy if it's walking down the street.
You can have a moody canary, can't you? And what they do is they often tell the police what you've been doing. They're known for that.
Mm.
Yeah.
So basically,
that for you is proof that the supernatural exists. A bird in a cage got a little bit annoyed, wasn't chirping as much as it normally did. Who knows why? There could have been a little draft up its. You know, and exactly.
That's
anyway,
a medical term.
Anyway, a man came in and did whatever he did.
Yeah. Mr. Exorcist, though, Steve. This wasn't any bloke off the street. This was Mr. Exorcist.
Yeah,
yeah. So
and for you, that's the proof that there's
just because, like, if it was a person, you go, oh, they're playing up for the camera.
Yeah,
you know,
a budgie could possibly act like that, Steve.
Yeah, I see what you mean. You're saying a budgie would not be trying to. It wouldn't be trying to become famous.
No,
or just want to
not
get on
like
the telly.
Not like Lassie.
No, sure.
It was
sure.
basically a show off.
Yeah, or so, Champion the Wonder Horse.
So yeah.
What do you think?
I think
I've changed my tune, Rick. I don't know about you.
I have, and I think we should play a record.
I'd love to get Mr. Exorcist in. Wouldn't that be amazing?
Never dabble with things you don't understand.
Sorry.
Like women. See what I did there?
Oh, he's turned that back on me. I've never had this sort of
Steve was thinking, he's not that ugly.
Ooh.
Blimey, here we go, we were laughing at Carl! Can we focus on one person at a time, Rick, please? Let's destroy him first.
Oh, God. Tell him what you said to me when that record was playing about the Jaffa Cakes. He bought some Jaffa Cakes, which was lovely. He went across the road and he handed out the Jaffa Cakes. And then I went, oh, thanks very much. And then what did you say?
I just remember learning at school. I'm not, like, making fun of the illness, because it's not funny. But, they cure cancer.
Jaffa Cakes cure cancer?
Not like, fully.
Right. They just go some way to helping.
Yeah. Do you know, it'll sort of help. If you've got it, you can't say, right, get me a load of Jaffa Cakes.
Right.
But I think it sort of puts a bit of a stop to it if you haven't got it. Do you know what I mean? It's like having vitamin tablets.
Is this medically proven? Should we get Dr. Fox down here to confirm that?
I'm not sure.
I can't. I actually can't cope. You're just play a record. Play a record.
Can I just, if anyone has ever survived cancer thanks to Jaffa Cakes, please call in.
No, but I didn't say
that. He said, and then he went, it's the orange thing in it. And then he tried to read it. He said, I wonder if it's, and he tried to read out this scientific name. Farrah Munch, got ya. XFM 104.9. Well, as we promised, some feng shui. What do you want to know? Ratio of witness. It's one of those little books that you see at the sort of like the front desk of like Waterstones or Dillon's or one of those. And it's just, it's a little guide. It's, should I say what it is? I'm allowed, aren't I? Lillian Tu's little book of, feng shui. And, obviously she can't go into it in depth, but it's some little, you know.
Just some little sort of nuggets, I suppose.
Yeah, ratio of windows. The ratio of windows to doors in your rooms should not exceed 3-1. Too many windows cause all your luck to seep away. Obviously. Hello. it is also better not to have windows on the wall opposite the door.
Is that the case in your place, Carl? Because you may need to brick that up when you get back later.
I always remember, I used to work nights.
Yeah.
Right? And it was when my brother just sort of got kicked out of the army.
Yeah.
I mean, Mum and Dad went away on holiday, so he was staying with us.
He's got to write a book, this bloke. You've got to write a book, Carl. Go on.
I came back, yeah, and there was women everywhere. There's women in every bed in the house. I thought, where am I going to sleep?
Had he set up a brothel? What?
So, no, it's just a bit of a womp.
That's so impressive, though, a girl in every single bed. I mean,
he was mad. So, I slept on the sofa downstairs, and I didn't sleep that well.
Yeah.
But I slept on it before when it was facing a different way.
Sure.
And I had a good sleep.
So for you, that's so proved the worth of feng shui.
Yeah, I think there's something in it.
Did you honestly think there's something in it, though?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Okay, well, just read a few of the others, Rick.
Okay, well, it's not, I think most people know this one. Display the three-legged frog for luck. Look for a three-legged frog. You can buy one from any Chinese supermarket. and place it in the vicinity of your front door, facing inwards as if it has just come into the house. Don't place the frog facing the door! Please.
Oh, come on, people.
What
think you, before you place your frog.
I mean, this really is, I mean, but.
What's the last page? Because that will be the most important one.
Do you reckon?
Yep.
The last one,
the wealth vase. Make a wealth vase and keep it hidden in your cupboard. It can be made of gold, crystal or glass. Can I just say something? If you've got a vase made of gold, you're probably all right for money anyway.
Yeah, sure. But this is the wealth vase. How do you make the wealth vase?
Fill it with semi-precious stones and with soil taken from a rich man's garden.
So just find the soil of a rich man. Take some soil from
the- This is like bury a piece of steak and the wart will go.
Yeah.
I have a tooth of frog. This is-
It's the one where with the gods. Can you find that one?
Oh, where's that one? Yeah.
What do you make of feng shui, Carl? Is it something you believe in?
Well, like I said, I didn't sleep well on the sofa when it was-
So for you, that's proof positive.
Yeah, you've got to get it right, haven't you?
I'd like Carl to read this out.
Okay.
Yeah, do you mind? Read it out, just read it out loud.
Which one?
Yeah, the gods are here, right, okay?
Just read that, that's such a good bit.
The gods.
Yeah.
Of wealth into your home.
Yeah.
The Chinese have several gods of wealth.
Yeah.
Which they display in their homes to attract, what? Prosperity.
Prosperity.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. My personal favourite is T.C. Chi Yi.
Yeah.
Who sits on a tiger.
He sits on a tiger?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait.
It's pretty difficult to find this fella.
Yep.
If you could use Kang Kung, or the three star gods, oh, no.
Read them out!
Read out the names of the star gods.
F-U-K.
Read it out! Just read that! It's a Chinese god! You're allowed to say Chinese god for the radio!
No.
You are allowed to say
Chinese- you're allowed to say it, you say it then.
Well, you're so immature!
Read the three of them out, really.
Okay, if he is difficult to find, you should use Quan Kung or the three star gods, Fuck Luck and Sal, all of whom bring wealth and prosperity.
Then what were the names of the gods again? Because I'm making a note at home, Rick,
well, it's a Chinese god!
Yeah, there's Quan Kung, or you can use Luck, Sal, or-
You can't.
What? But it's a god. F-U-K. That's how it's
pronounced. Yeah, I assume. I don't know. If we're pronouncing it wrong, I'm really apologise.
Apologies. If we're offending anyone who's of an oriental persuasion. But that's Quan Kung or Luck, Sal or Fuck. And any of those gods are available at a Chinese supermarket.
Near you?
Yeah. That's Feng Shui. It's an ancient art. You can't- give me that look.
I mean, when you've been saying I've got a round head, I was a bit like, yeah, everyone has. Stop having a go.
Yeah.
And I saw this picture last week. I thought, God, he's right.
Can't we just pop it on the XOM website?
I'd rather not.
I'll go on, just
Steve,
get someone-
have you seen that man in a jar without a brain?
Sorry, is that a product you can buy? In, like, Sainsbury's?
Is it a dream you had yesterday?
Man in
you
a wondered jar.
If you could- yes, hello, could you make my dream into reality, please? Well, we can't, actually, sir. In, plastic would be good.
Sorry, what do you mean?
In the future, you'll be able to download your dreams and then just, like, act them out again, probably, in the year 2000 or something.
Soothsayer.
No, there's some museum somewhere.
Yeah.
That's got this little fella who was born without a brain, and he's in a jar, and it's just that he's got a really round head.
Right.
And when I saw this picture, I thought, God, it just reminded me of this little fella in a jar.
Oh, and what do you mean he's born without a brain?
He was born without a brain.
So it's a baby?
It's not a little fella.
Yeah, but it's weird.
Do you know the difference? Do you have conversations with, like, people in prams thinking, that fella's little and he doesn't talk much?
Yeah.
You know babies aren't, like, little people?
Well, maybe...
Well, they are little people, but, I mean, they're not very small adults. They're not, like, midgets.
They don't do a job of work, is what we're saying.
What do you mean?
I didn't read about it, I just saw the picture. And
this is where you're going wrong, Carl. This is always your mistake. You see the picture, you don't read the little caption.
But what do you mean? How do you think
guess at what you think the meaning
is? But how did you know he didn't have a brain?
He said something like, the brainless man.
Yeah, but they, people say that about you. It doesn't mean you literally you haven't got a spinal
cord. I bet somebody's seen it and knows what I mean. It's a famous picture.
Right, call in 08700 800 1234. Once again, you win a prize if you can tell us what Carl is talking about. Just in general. It's an ongoing competition. We're trying to find some CDs to anyone who knows what Carl is talking about. Stereophonics, Vegas, 2 times. Well, we've had calls confirming that there was indeed, a fetus, or a stillborn child.
A pickled baby.
A pickled baby. No wonder it died. Born without a brain. But everyone has, you know, pointed out that it wasn't a little fella.
It certainly wasn't a little fella.
No.
Because it had been in the jar for a long time, I think it had aged a bit.
What are you basing that on?
You do carry on growing, yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Well, your ears and your nose.
Your ears and your nose. And your eyes don't grow, so, you could probably, yeah.
I'll dig it out for you.
Yeah.
Imagine if like, there was an experiment where they were raising a child just based on the information that we said on the radio.
Yeah.
What kind of a person
it was like
would they
download,
be?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And what kind of information would they
and
have?
It took everything literally.
Exactly.
Who needs enemies? Good question, lads. Nobody. 6FM 104.9. I'm Ricky Gervais.
Oh, they should print a little book of those. They're great. Oh, how you can relate any song or artist to anything else.
Easy.
Joyful.
Easy. Well, yeah. So me and Carl went out for a beer, and it was great, wasn't it?
Yeah, enjoy yourself.
We started
yeah,
off, and you met my mate Robin, didn't you?
Yeah.
And some of the stories. Do you want to tell Steve some things about Robin that
Robin,
you learned?
Do you know him well?
Yes.
Well, do you know about his worm problem as a kid?
Go on.
Right. He what I can remember is he had worms as a kid. Not sure how you get them. He never answered me. He was getting a bit touchy about it.
Right.
This is like the second time I met him. I think he was a bit annoyed that Ricky told me about his problem.
What, yes. Now straight away, you not being there, instinctively, what do you think went on with this story about worms?
My suspicion
yeah.
is rather like when you told a group of people that Robin had once suckled milk from a cow's udder.
Yeah.
Did you mention that as well?
Yeah.
Yeah. My suspicion is that, like the cow story, the worm story is not true.
But why would he get so sort of uppity about it.
Well, imagine if, not true. Imagine if he, that wasn't the first time he'd done it. Imagine if he did that every single time he was with somebody for the first time and Robin was just met them. He tells that, he will tell that story to anyone.
But they do say there's no smoke without fire.
Poor Robin. I also told him.
That's a fable.
I also told him that the way Robin cured these worms was because the doctor told his mother, right, to hold a piece of ham or cheese near Robin's anus so the worms would come out for the food, and he believed it.
I'll tell you why, though.
I said, Robin used to sit on Spam to try and get the worms out, and he believed it.
But Steve, right, do you remember that story about three or four years ago where there was some bloke in the army, he went away to somewhere, Vietnam or whatever, he was messing about in the woods.
Messing about in the woods? Shouldn't he have been fighting?
Whatever. Yeah. Right, and he walked through some lake, and I think he'd cut his toe or something on something, and some worm of some sort crawled in the gash.
Yeah.
And it was in his body, and the doctor said, we've got to get this out of your body. So what they did was, they said, right, the thinnest part or something of your body that things can crawl through is on the top of your head. So they wrapped
where the skull is.
So they wrapped some bacon.
No, they didn't.
They did.
That's all right. So he's gone in by the toe. So what we do is, I'll tell you what, that worm's probably heading straight for the head. We put a bit of bacon on it. The thinnest part of the body is the skull. Of course, it's not the thinnest part of the body. It's where your brain case is, isn't it? It's the hard the skull.
There was a reason for it. And it was like they stuck some bacon on his head. And
as ever, the vital piece of information, i.e. the reason, Carl seems to have forgotten.
Because the worm was in his body, and they said everyone likes the smell of bacon.
Including even a Vietnamese lake worm.
They love bacon.
Remember last week when I said about the little fella with the bone with no brain, and you were proved wrong.
No. We were saying it wasn't a little fella. We were saying it was a stillborn child. It wasn't a little fella.
You're changing it now. You weren't having any of it last week.
Right, hang on a minute. I'm getting confused. There was a Vietnamese snake that went inside of a soldier.
A little, like, maggot or some sort that you have to get out of your body because it causes problems.
Yes, and so in order to get it out of the body, they strapped bacon to his head.
Yeah.
That is great. This doctor.
And did that work?
I think so. They had a picture of him smiling.
Oh, God, what, the worm or the bloke?
The bloke.
Oh, dear.
Honestly, I hope someone knows the story and right. Just. It was about 3 years ago, I reckon.
Okay.
And, yeah, it did work.
G.I. bacon.
So this is why I went.
And so what, the worm burrowed out of his head to get the bacon?
Get to the bacon.
Right. That's great.
So this is why when Robin was telling his story, I was a little bit disappointed if it wasn't true.
Right.
Because in a way,
you know, Robin's never been to Vietnam.
No, but what would do you really think that Robin? Well, as Robin said at the time, Carl, why would I sit on ham then tell Ricky Gervais? It's a very good point.
Because if he was a kid, you do daft things like that as a kid.
Right.
See, it's the telling Ricky Gervais though.
Yeah.
No. No, I mean you know, you might call up.
Yeah.
But no, I keep myself to myself.
Yeah.
Then you don't get bogged down in the office politics and stuff.
So yeah. Is there a lot of office politics here?
I don't know. I don't get involved in it.
Oh yeah. Proved your point.
So when we're away and we're like out of action, who other than Suzanne, who will you talk to of the day?
How will you get a sort of feedback from the world? How will you get sort of like input and
I always, if ever I've got like a question on anything, the internet's sat there and I can just go online and find out.
The internet is good.
It's brilliant.
But it's not all verified.
What do you mean?
It's not all verified.
It's not all necessarily factually accurate.
Anyone can put things onto the internet. It's that, you know, that it's freaks and things that put on things
one, right?
Like.
Well, here's one that I read in the week, right?
One.
About this woman.
Yeah.
She was a bit of a punk, and to get her hair done like she wanted it.
Super glue.
Right, no. She got lard. Apparently it's a popular thing, you might know. Put lard on your head.
Yeah.
And you put it in the oven. Now, apparently the heat that you get from the oven is different from the sort of heat you get from an air dryer. Right? And she had to do that to get the style that she wanted. But anyway, she comes into money or whatever, treats herself to a microwave. right?
It doesn't. It's not true. Carl.
Opens the door, jams the things, you know, like the little catch, so the microwave works. She jams it with a screwdriver or a knife or something.
Yeah.
Puts the microwave on, sticks her head in, boils her brain.
Don't be ridiculous.
Right? Well, why is that ridiculous?
Boils her brain.
She boiled her brain.
She boiled her brain.
And this is what's good about the internet. I went straight from that, and there was a subject about brains. And do you know that Russell Crowe, when he dies, is given his brain to charity or something, some sort of some people who can do stuff with it.
She gave hers to Pot Noodle.
Vesta.
Yeah.
Oh, that's boiling the skull.
Yeah.
That's not true. No.
It's not true, Carl.
It's the same as the woman who put her poodle in the microwave, isn't it? And all
just
that.
Just urban myths.
They're urban myths.
But again, where does it start?
Someone made it up.
Yeah.
For a laugh.
They're just too convenient urban myths. Everyone you can tell an urban myth's not true, because it's always, this happened to a mate of mine, and when you say what happened then, they go, don't know, that was it. Was it? Was that it? Was it? Someone boiled a brain and that was it. There was no more story.
Were there any dates, locations, times? I think it was in Belgium.
There's that one that a bloke, right, was gonna get a phone call at 4 o'clock to find out if his business was, you know, okay, right? And if he didn't get the phone call, he knew he was broke, destitute. So, dead on 4 o'clock, the phone didn't ring, so he went up to the roof, his office, and he jumped off to commit suicide. And as he was passing his window, the phone was ringing.
Oh, no.
Carl, it didn't happen.
Didn't happen.
Think it through.
Think it through. Who told that story? Who told that story? As he hit the pavement at 120 miles an hour.
He's the only person who could have known that series of incidents.
Also, why didn't he wait, as his life's at stake, why didn't he wait till 5 past? Actually, I'm gonna give it 5 minutes, just in case.
Just in case the lines are busy.
Yeah. And what sort of bloke goes out, I'll call you at 4, okay, if your business, well, call me anyway. No, no. If I don't call exactly 4, then, no, you commit suicide. Commit suicide. I would, because if I don't call at 4, oh, that's the end of it. Well, call me anyway. No, that's not the way I work. Why can't you just call me and tell me the other way? Well, I'm telling you, I would do it. If you're bust, I don't call. Can't you just call to verify in case something goes wrong? What if he's engaged? He'd want to be engaged. Just commit suicide at 4, please. It didn't happen, Carl. And the other one, right? A bloke, right? He's on a train station, and I'll tell you how I heard it. He's waiting for a crew station, whatever, and he shits himself. As you do. And so he goes, oh, my train's in 5 minutes, I need... So he runs across to Millett's and goes, quick, Levi's, 36. The bloke just puts it in a bag, he runs onto the train, he goes into the toilet, takes his, trousers and pants off.
He's soiled.
Yes. Throws them out of the window, I won't be needing those again. Cleans himself off, open the bags, it's a jacket!
Oh.
No, it didn't happen, Carl!
It didn't happen, Carl!
At what point did he go into it and go, quick, Levi's 36, and the bloke went, sorry, Levi's 36, what, a pair, shall I wrap them, shall I wrap, just wrap whatever it is, do you want to look, no, I'm not looking when you're putting it in the bag, please, right, well, 36 white stories, well, not, don't say anything.
I've told you 36 Levi's, and put it in a bag and charge me for it.
Yeah.
I don't want to discuss it further.
Yeah.
There was one,
here we go.
There was one about a woman whose husband died, and she had him cremated.
Yeah.
And made like a little egg timer out of him.
Right.
And she said, I did that so it can still help around the kitchen.
Well, that might be true. That might be a joke.
That's quite sweet.
That might be true.
That is a true story, again. It was all-
No, not again, because the ones I just told weren't. Nor is the boiling the brains in a bag curry microwave
head story true.
Yeah. They're too convenient.
Will you be buried or cremated?
What?
Will you be buried or cremated?
I don't know. Cremated. I imagine.
What you say?
I don't know. It's out of my hands.
Yeah, I haven't thought about
it. I've not thought it through and I don't care either way.
Have you heard the one
about- I'm just worried that we're getting into a macabre world now of- ashes, boiled heads. So I think we should play some music, let people just calm down.
Levi's.
Just think about some of the urban myths they've maybe heard, assess them, maybe they are absolute bollocks.
Yeah.
And, they can move on from it.
Well, it's just that, the death thing, right?
Yeah.
There was an argument on there about, do you know that Twilight Zone or whatever it was, Tales of the Unexpected?
Oh, yeah.
Where the woman got buried alive.
Yeah.
They were saying how, like, years ago, they'd bury people thinking they're dead.
Yeah.
And they've recently, like, dug coffins up, and then the people who were in the coffin weren't dead, they might have just been, like, in some sort of deep sleep or
catatonic.
Whatever. And they've lifted the lid off.
Yeah.
And there's scratch marks on the thing.
Yeah.
And that's pretty scary.
That makes you think. I mean, I hope they check these days. That's all. I'd like to play a beautiful song now by Cat Stevens. On the how did you enjoy Edinburgh, by the way, anyway? Because I saw you up there briefly with you and, Nick Frost, your new mates, Nick Frost and Simon Pegg. You know, he prefers them to us now.
I know, apparently, I could tell that from just talking to him,
It was just, the way he was sort of looking at them, everything, like, he was just smiling at Nick Frost, it's his new best chum, you love Nick Frost, don't
you? Would you have preferred it, right, if I went to Edinburgh and had to sit with some people that I really didn't like? Would you have been happier for me?
No, do you know, but
I had a great time with Simon and Nick, and they'd nice people.
He kept going to, oi, Nick, tell Ricky that story. And Nick and Simon, well, all it was, right, and their ghost stories, that's, he loves them because they believe in ghosts.
Oh.
It's not just
their great blokes with great sense of humour, just because they believe in ghosts. And you go and tell them that, he goes, how'd you explain that? I was going, well, I wasn't there. What was that one you told me and it was completely wrong? About the...
It was, oh yeah, right, it's years ago.
Oh yeah.
In olden days.
Oh sure.
When ghosts roamed the earth.
Once upon a time, you mean?
Yeah.
Some doctor or something who was into, like, the way bodies work, they got their head cut off.
The doctor?
Yeah, he was doing a bit of an experiment.
And he cut his own head off?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was about, so when my head's in the basket, I'm gonna blink my eyes.
Right. Okay, sorry, hang on, let him finish.
And,
so the doctor has chopped his own head off and he's told everyone, I'm gonna blink my eyes.
He's in the basket and he goes like, right, I'm gonna blink my eyes about, you know, as many times as I can. So quick, count them. And they count and he got to like 15 before he died.
Now this is how Carl told me that. Till Nick Frost explained that, Carl told me, like, he said, right, well a bloke, right, he had his head cut off, and when his head was in the basket, he went, count how many times I can blink. And I went, well that's rubbish. He went, no, and Nick went, well no, he actually said, when my head's in the basket. And Carl went, alright. I said, Carl, do you know the subtle difference? Do you see the subtle difference?
I have to say though, guys, I still don't really understand what went on there. You've both lost me.
The story is that a bloke who'd been found doing,
You mean that Carl just explained it and that was a clear version? Because I still don't know what you're talking about, Carl.
Well, this bloke had his head cut off for experiments against God. He was a doctor in the, you know, in olden times.
Yeah.
And when they cut his head off...
Why did they cut his head off?
Because it was...
He was executed.
Crimes against... Exactly, he was executed, yeah. And, he said to his assistant, when my head's in the basket, I'm gonna blink, count how many times I blink and write it down as an experiment, right? Carl told it to me, like, his head was cut off and he went in the basket, and when his head was in the basket, he looked up and said, count how many times I blink. Yeah. I love that. I love the difference in that story.
Yeah.
Both rubbish, but, you know, one's possible and one isn't.
Why do you believe anything, that you're told except when we tell you the truth?
Right, here's one.
Christ.
Ghosts and that we got talking about.
Sure.
And Nick said, right, he said, you'll like this one.
Huh.
He said, my auntie, was having loads of problems.
Why are you whispering? It's not illegal to talk about ghosts on the radio.
No, but
he's hearing this.
So, the auntie's in the house and that, and, furniture's moving about all the time.
Oh, God.
And they were like, no,
Steve, you told me this one. This is such rubbish, mate.
No, come on, let's listen.
I'm gonna leave it to you. I'm gonna sit back and enjoy. I'm just gonna watch your face, Steve.
Right.
Sorry, so I missed the beginning there, Carl. There's an auntie
basically, Nick's auntie.
Right.
In the house, things moving around all the time. Oh, it was just annoying every time she tidied up. It was like,
oh, it's just annoying.
Making a mess.
It was one part annoying to two parts scary.
Yeah.
So.
So stuff was
moving around all the time, and they said, right, rather than-
Right, we need an housekeeper.
Yeah. Rather than having the house a mess, until we sort
this out- Stop it! I've got the vicar coming round! Stop moving stuff around!
Oh, yeah, go on.
They said-
That shouldn't be in the pants drawer!
Let's put all the furniture in one room, right?
Right.
So, just have one room that's a mess, and have all the others empty.
Because I love the poltergeist can't really, it can move wardrobes around, but it can't open the door to put it in another room.
Yeah.
Poltergeist going, oh, I'm just making this room messy. I wish someone opened the door so I could, go on.
Yeah, but, so all this stuff's in this room.
So they moved all their furniture into one room.
They put like the drawers in there and everything, and it was really uncomfortable, because they were all like on top of each other.
They sat in the room with all the stuff?
Yeah, they had to, because that's where the three-piece suite was.
Okay.
Oh, God!
Right.
Oh, God!
So they sat there, like, all crumpled up on that, but nothing can move because it's so tight. Things, yeah. I think things were trying to move,
but everything
was so tight, it's
they
just
foxed
like,
that poltergeist.
So anyway, one night they sat there, like, sort of a bit awkward watching the telly and that, and, you hear some banging.
Yeah.
In the next room. So, she goes, oh, God, what's that?
Oh, he hadn't moved in, had he, the ghost?
So,
to some of the empty rooms.
So there's this bang-
He's moved some friends and family in.
There's this banging about going on,
no,
so
this, this, this,
she gets up, right?
Yeah.
And what it is, they had the baby in the next room, because there wasn't much room for the cot.
Right, they left the baby with the ghost.
So, they go into the room where the baby is, and the banging-
Yeah.
Is like, do you know those plastic balls you get that you can chuck around the room and like, they go mental?
Right.
The ones that you chuck once and they keep bouncing for ages.
Yeah.
That was bouncing around the room.
Why? What, the baby had thrown it?
It in all the walls, and the baby was there, stood in the cot, sort of laughing.
Right.
And looking at the ball, and wherever it looked, the ball went.
Yeah.
And then she said, stop doing that.
Yeah.
And the ball just stopped.
Did it?
And it rolled a bit and stopped.
Right. So the baby had thrown the ball and it was watching it as it bounced around the room?
It wasn't throwing it, it was in control of it.
No, the point is, Steve, the baby had been doing it. It would have been the baby all along.
The baby had been messing with the furniture. It was
so
the baby
it's a super
that had the
baby.
Power. It's a baby that had the power.
Special baby.
It's
special
a baby that
powers.
Had the power. It's
what
a baby
power?
That had the power.
What,
the power,
what's the power
of telekinesis.
Right.
They were then trying to convince me that telekinesis was not like all the other stuff that I didn't believe in, but that was a science.
Right.
Telekinesis was possible.
Yes.
Yeah, it's not like ghosts and demons and all that sort of telekinesis is different.
Yeah.
That's a science.
But Nick's auntie saw it, and
I love the fact that you're telling me that someone else's auntie saw it. So I should be satisfied with that.
Yeah.
I should be satisfied with that. I mean,
no.
So does she still live in one room with all her possessions?
No, I think
the baby grew out of it. Apparently,
it grew.
The baby grew out of it.
So it doesn't use its telekinesis powers anymore.
Well, no, it's like in Carrie, innit? She was upset for a bit, and then she got over it.
Okay, I'm just gonna say one thing, Carl. That was a film. Do you want to play a record or? Oh.
Get free.
All right, on XFM 104.9. Can I just tell you a story that Carl told me a couple of weeks ago?
Is this another ghost story? Another
spooky
story?
Yeah. I called him out, I was, what are you doing? He said, oh, I said, I've just been reading ghost stories again. He said, you don't believe in them, but how do you explain this? Right, I went, go on. He said, I'll tell you as he told me it. He went, bloke, right, just sitting at home, doing, you know, watching telly with his cat. And, the phone rings, and it's a bloke going, is that fire, in your oven okay now? Cause your wife called. And he went, Carl went, well, one, there was no fire in the oven. Two, he wasn't married. I went, right. Go on, he went, well. Then, right, there was a knock at the door and there was two sort of people in sort of white coats and they came and said, oh, we've come about that fire. Your wife called us. He went, one, there isn't a fire in my oven and two, I'm not even married. Right? And he said, and they saw the cat and they sort of, they looked at the cat, it looks a bit weird, the cat came out, and it was nothing. He said, and then he went back. It sat down, phone rings, and they said, oh, did they sort out the fire in the oven that your wife told us about?
Oh.
He went, one, there is no fire in my oven, two, I haven't got a wife. And Carl went, what do you think of that? I went, that's not it. He went, yeah, I went.
That's the end of the story.
What? He went, well, how'd you explain that? I went, explain what? I thought it was going to say, a year later we got married but she died in an oven fire. Right? I thought it was going to be that, and I went,
that's people winding him up.
Yeah, or someone did report a fire in an oven and their name was Johnson and they looked up Johnson, they got the wrong thing, it was the gas board or, and they sent round to the wrong person, right? You know, he went, yeah, I said, I explained it to him, he went, yeah, why did they look at the cat funny?
Oh, man alive, Carl. This is really weird, right? I was,
I was in my house once, right, and the doorbell rang.
Yeah.
Right, I opened the door, and there was no one there.
Yeah.
Right? And then I looked across the street,
and
right,
some kids
and there were some kids running away.
Yeah.
Now, how do you explain that?
Yeah.
There was another time, right, where, like, I opened the door, and there was a bloke goes, "You've ordered pizza." I went, "I haven't ordered pizza." And I heard my mate upstairs giggling and putting the phone down.
Yeah. How do you explain that? Carl, seriously, what did you, why did you tell me that story? What did you think, what do you think it was weird about that?
The fact that it was three different people.
Is this all the information? Is that the entire story? Have you,
it was
you,
three different people.
Did you fall asleep and not read
about
the end?
A fire that didn't happen, about a wife that didn't exist, and a cat that didn't look happy.
Oh, I'm gonna have a heart attack, Carl. What? I mean, why did they look at the cat funny?
Because what? Cats don't like spirits, do they?
What? And the other blokes were ghosts.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
So these are kind of beetle about type ghosts. These are ghosts to walk the earth as the undead, just winding people up slightly.
That's lovely. That is lovely.
Seriously,
a cat that did not look happy.
But seriously, why would ghosts wander around just like winding people up?
Oh,
maybe something did happen there years ago.
Mm.
Some fire. Some woman might have died in the house of a fire or something.
Yeah,
and it sort of all happened again.
Bit yeah. Yeah, it's certainly a mystery.
It's a mystery. I mean,
What's this book you were reading? You were reading a book, which is interesting enough.
It was the Fortean Times.
Oh, Carl.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know what to say.
Well, I'll tell you this, Carl. Here's a track that will spook you right out. This is Warren Zevon from, was it, like, about 1979, early 80s?
Oh, great track.
Werewolves of London. Play this, Carl. But don't be scared. From 1978, Carl, Werewolves of London by Warren Zevon. Are you a fan of that?
It's alright,
great track, isn't it?
Fans of Warren Zevon, maybe if you should know, he's got a new album out. As we speak. Although, if you're a fan, you probably know that already.
Yeah.
If you aren't a
people
fan.
People who hate him would be interested in knowing that he's got a new album out.
Yeah.
Do you believe in, I think Werewolves. Lycanthropy? Is it not called?
What's that, sorry?
Lycanthropy.
What's lycanthropy?
Isn't that werewolfism?
Really?
Isn't it? Do you believe in that, Carl?
They've found stuff, haven't they? They've found kids walking about who are all airy. Because they sort of grew up with wolves and that.
Yeah.
So. No. You see, two things there. You cannot take on acquired characteristics genetically. So, if you grew up with wolves, it wouldn't suddenly make you hairy.
There's been stories on it, and I reckon most people have, or a lot of people have seen the stories. It's a popular thing.
You mean the kids that are born hairy?
No, there's kids who have been born hairy, right?
Yeah, that's it.
No, but listen, and they walk around on all fours, and they drink milk from a saucer.
Steve, this is
no,
too
remember,
easy.
Listen, remember that time with the maggot in the head?
Yeah.
Getting out with bacon, and you were like laughing, and then people called up and said, "Yeah, I've seen that. I've read about that."
Yeah,
this is the same thing.
Have you seen an XFM listener up close? Have you ever looked?
They drink milk from a saucer.
Yeah, they've got to be kept on leads. People who listen to this show.
There's no point in me telling you about stuff.
There is. It's comedy
gold. When you were out of school, did you keep arguing with the teacher saying you're talking rubbish there?
Teachers didn't teach us about werewolf boys and ghosts. They taught us maths. God. Right. Tell the story about the manhole cover.
Right. In the same magazine as the one with the cat and the fire and that.
Don't tell me that story again, it gives me
a shame. Yeah, a cat that's got a weird expression on his face is against God.
Anyway, this isn't a scary story, this was just, like, physics. Physics.
Yeah, yeah.
It was going on about the, nuclear bomb and how powerful it is. And, they put a manhole cover on top of one.
Okay.
Blew it up.
Yeah.
Never saw the manhole cover again.
Man alive, Carl. Unexplained.
What's going on there? Something weird is happening there. Oh.
If anyone has ever seen that manhole cover,
please
get in touch. We'd love to know where it is.
Oh, that's fantastic. What sort of experiment is that? I imagine all these scientists on multi-billion-pound research budgets, they're going, we test everything. What would you do to a manhole cover? Don't know.
That's like letting a couple of students.
Do you reckon it can send a traffic cone into orbit? Go on then, put it on there. I love that. I imagine that. What? What value is that? I'm not sure what we could do. We could let the put the manhole cover on it and aim it and then blow the bomb up and it would the manhole cover would have someone's eye out. Fire it. See if you can fire manhole covers off the nuclear bomb. Whatever. Try bangers to a bomb. See if it's louder.
Oh God. Okay, listen, Carl. Play another track and then afterwards, can we probe your views on the week's news?
If you want,
we'll do a bit of a white van Carl session.
Carl, I've met Carl a couple of times in our sabbatical, and he said to me once, he said, oysters. So I said, have you ever tried oysters? I don't like them. And I went, he said, oh, it's just a thing about swallowing them whole, you know. He went, well, the reason you have to do that is just they're fatally poisonous. And if you bite into them, they kill you. And I went, well, of course they don't. He went, yeah. I went, well, of course. They wouldn't. What have you chewed on? I said. He said, no. I said, well, so you swallow them whole and they're not poisonous. He went, yeah, ah, see. He said, so, he said, when you swallow heroin in a Johnny, he says, that doesn't kill you, does it? That was it.
Oh.
And then, about a week later, he went, I was wrong about them. Yeah, I went, well, he said, yeah, yeah, yeah. And what did you say?
It's if you eat them and then you have some whiskey.
They turn deadly when whiskey comes into contact with them.
Yeah, when they've had a drink.
When they've had a drink, they get a bit rowdy in your stomach. They right. Start fighting, they can
yeah,
cause
hilarious.
So what are you saying now? Are you saying you don't believe that?
Am I saying what?
Are you saying you don't believe
Look,
that?
He thinks he's got us here. He thinks he's got us here. Yeah, I don't believe that if you eat an oyster, then drink some whiskey, you die.
You might not die straight away, but you won't feel.
Eventually, 50 years time.
If you've got to keep on drinking whiskey.
Yeah, 50,
a bottle a day.
50 or 60 years later, he was dead.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oyster and a bottle of whiskey a day. Oh. Then, out of nowhere, 40 years later.
Where does this information come from, Carl?
If some doctor called up now.
Yeah.
And put you right, would you believe him?
If it wasn't Dr. Fox.
Yeah.
What about the airy lads growing up with the werewolves and that?
They didn't grow up with werewolves.
Werewolves. Grow up with werewolves.
You're confused
they're
about three different
just a genetic
stories,
mutation where the, you know, they were born with very, very hirsute.
There were a couple of kids, yes,
they didn't
we know.
Grow up with wolves and you can't kill them with a silver bullet. I mean, you're confusing two things.
There were
you?
Some kids who were very, very hairy, yes.
Yeah.
They're in folklore. There were some kids who grew up with wolves, yes. I don't think the two are connected.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's no such thing as werewolves, Carl.
You
believe me, I saw a documentary on it on the History Channel. You'd have loved it.
You grew up
the
with a magpie. You know, you don't flap around, do you, and steal people's jewellery.
What was the thing you told me about snails?
Have you ever had any post that looks like it's been opened?
Occasionally, yeah.
All right. Well, what it is, it's not your postman having
a sneaky look.
A sneaky look. Problem is,
right,
slugs.
The problem's slugs.
Slugs at night, they like nipping about and that, and it gets a bit cold. And in London, like in the country, they go into the grass, don't they?
Right.
But in London, it's like, oh, what can we do? And they go in letterboxes.
Right? Slugs go in letterboxes.
Get in letterboxes. It's nice and warm in there, dry and what have you. And
these are homeless slugs, aren't they? Ones that have lost their shell.
When they're in there, they only found out that they love glue.
They
and
love
they've,
glue.
They've been eating the glue off the stamps.
Right.
And people have been getting charged for post because it hasn't had stamps on it. It's like, well, they put a stamp on it.
Yeah.
It's like it's, slugs have been eating it.
Sure.
And they also eat the glue that's on the actual envelope shutter. And it's a real popular problem, this, that letters are being lost and opened and all that stuff. Yeah. Slugs.
Are slugs like stealing postal orders and things and cashing them in and stuff?
Yeah, again, you know, if there's a doctor, if there's a postman.
Yeah.
Well, with us two expert witnesses, a doctor and a postman. So, so posties is a real problem.
When we see a slug's trail or a snail's trail,
it's glue.
That's the glue they've stolen, is it? That's a little.
I'm not going to say yes to that. I'm not sure.
But we could follow that trail and find them, and they'd have a big sort of
big pile of letters.
Yeah, our stamps and
yeah, there they are.
Like birthday cards for our aunts.
Yeah, but £2 notes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fantastic. Wow. Slugs. Wow. So, oysters and whiskey kill you, and slugs.
Be very careful. If you're going to go out this evening, you're thinking of having a whiskey, maybe some oysters, be very, very careful.
Yeah, and if you are going to post a letter, please do not use tasty glue. Met Carl in the week against
Steve.
I told you you shouldn't do this. But then he starts saying things like, "Oh, is this loud with the people?" I go, "No, save it," and we just sit there. And I'm scared to talk in case he comes up. But you did tell me a couple of little things, didn't you? True stories that you know that I mean I enjoy. Can you tell Steve about the doctor?
Right.
Oh God. Is this something that happened to a friend of yours, or is this?
No. I read about it.
You read about it. Okay.
There's this little lad, right?
Okay.
First of all, it's years ago, right?
When they didn't have
decent doctors in like every town and that.
Yeah.
And this little kid is dead ill, right?
Yeah.
And the local doctor.
Well, there's a phone call involved, so I don't want to give the impression that it's like medieval
times.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I didn't say that. I just said it's years ago.
Go on.
This kid's ill, right?
Yeah.
And he's lying in the bed and. He's all like, all going funny colour and that.
Yeah.
And his mum says, "I'm gonna get the local doctor around." The local doctor comes round. And, says, "Oh," said, I don't know what's up with him. He said, "Leave it with me."
Leave it with me.
The doctor said that.
I'll phone up, a top doctor.
Okay.
Who was in America or somewhere like that.
Yeah.
And, so he goes to the phone in his office and he calls America, and because it's years ago, the phone line isn't that good, it's all crackly and that, right?
Yeah.
So he's talking to the doctor and he's saying, "I've got this kid, he's a funny colour and, you know, he's really weak and that, I don't know what's
He's not giving him much to go on.
Right?
Sure.
So the American doctor, right?
Yeah.
He goes, "Yeah, what you want to do?" And it's all breaking up, right?
Yeah.
He goes, "What you got to do, you got to, it's all breaking up. You've got to give him some, parrot's blood, right?"
Some parrot's blood?
Well, that's what he thought he said, but the line was really bad.
Yeah.
He meant parents' blood, but he heard that he said parrot's blood. He said, "Right, I'll do that, leave it with me."
I can see where this is going.
He goes to, you know, a pet shop.
Yeah.
He says, "Give us like half a dozen parrots."
Sure.
Takes them round to the kid's house. Takes the blood from the parrots, puts it into the kid. Kid's fine.
The kid's fine.
It worked.
Such a load of shite in my life. I've never heard such twaddle, such just made up, enhanced, exaggerated bollocks in my life.
A load of old rubbish.
I mean, when he told me this, he said, the doctor said, "What do I do?" And the doctor on the other end said, "Give him some blood." And the doctor went, "Where do I get blood from?"
So hang on, wait,
where do I get blood from? Give him some parents' blood. Yeah.
But hang on, I just need to know where you read this. Where was this?
I stitched you up. You know what he said? He said, "So do you believe it?" I went, "Tell it to Steve." He went, "Do you believe it?" I went, "Tell it to Steve." Carl.
But where did you read it?
That was on the internet.
What?
About
where
illnesses.
Is it on the internet? Where,
I'm always looking at stuff. I was looking at stuff this morning because of, Yorah Geller last night. eating all that funny food and that. And also, they all got a bit scared last night, didn't they, with a snake.
Hmm. I didn't see that. Is this, I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of
Yeah,
Here?
Yeah, yeah. He got all worried about a snake getting on the, sort of wandering about in between the sleeping bags and stuff.
Yeah.
And, they were all scared, and it is so
easy. Leave it with me! Sorry, the doctor says, leave it with me. leave it with me.
Well, they were all scared because there's a snake, and it's so easy to find stuff out. Where are they? Where is this jungle?
Australia,
right.
I think.
Before they went, give it half an hour on the internet.
Yeah.
I found out with snakes, you don't need to worry, right?
Okay.
They're deaf, they haven't got any ears.
Right.
So as long as you're really quiet,
it'll
probably leave you alone.
Yeah.
And also, they don't have eyelids.
Uh-huh.
So they were suggesting if one's coming towards you, just, like, kick sand in its eyes. Because
yeah.
It can't blink and it leaves it a bit, like, annoyed.
Yeah.
And it wanders off. But they didn't do any research before they went.
Yeah. And that's, I think your knowledge would hold you in good stead. I don't think you need to know any more than you know. Well, we're going to come back to that, because he also explained to me where a saying comes from that I want you to be part of. But,
And also, you should mention as well, Carl, you've come up with a competition, is this right?
Brilliant competition.
He
thinks this can go to television.
Is this a good idea you've come up with?
Yeah.
Carl, I'm so looking forward to it.
I'm looking forward to it. Continuing our exposure of myths and legends of Rockfall Tale, we expose that myth that some maybe older rockers have had it, and they've got they were never any good, and the kids today.
Oh, I don't want to hear that.
People like Rod Stewart.
Rod Stewart's a great artist. He's a slightly laughable man, but a great artist.
Let's go back to when he was rocking.
When he cut the mustard.
Yeah. Rod Stewart. You wear it well.
Great tune.
On XFM 104.9. Yeah. This doctor, I mean, we should find out who he is, really, and if he's still practicing, because it worries me a little bit that he did that. Also, I mean, he thinks he's got away with it, but how could he be sure those parrots wouldn't talk?
True, true.
You know what I mean? There were six of them. They probably got together and they probably put it on the internet.
I mean, I feel that story, Carl, it asks more questions than it answers.
Yeah!
Really.
Like most of your stories.
Yeah, that's the problem. I always feel like I need a little bit more information. Like, did the parrot boy continue to live?
Yeah.
You know, to a ripe old age, or did he die weeks later after this charlatan doctor who was going around, you know, spurious
information? Did he break his nose trying to crack a big nut?
Mm. No, I think he's, he was alright. He lived to a...
See, I'd have shouted, if I was that doctor, I'd have shouted that down the phone. Are you sure you said parrot's blood?
Yeah.
You sure it was parrot's blood?
Listen, I mean, I'm not the best doctor in the world, but did you say parrot's blood?
Yeah, but what you're forgetting is you're going back to the time where, like, they used leeches to do, like,
No, we're not. We're going back to the late 70s if there's a phone call to America Direct.
Come on, Carl. They weren't calling America, like, in the medieval times or in the Victorian age. Come on, think about it, Carl.
Yeah.
You know, this has got to be like the you know, 30s or 40s, the earliest. You know?
Right.
I'm intrigued to know where this is. I think there's someone on the web who's just putting information on there to lead you astray.
Yeah.
Because you're the only person who finds this stuff. Other people are using this to write theses.
What were you looking up that then?
I always look up weird stuff.
What were you looking for?
But what do you type in the search engine to find parrot blood stories?
What were you looking for?
There was this woman with a weird head.
Why were you looking for that? What were you
doing? Just because I'd heard about it. I'd heard, like, someone talking about it on another station.
Right.
About this woman with a funny head.
Right. I love the fact you're intrigued with these things. You go in the basement of Waterstones or Dillon's or somewhere, and there's these medical books that you're loving, mate.
Yeah, but this is free on the internet, isn't it? It's all there.
Yeah.
So what do you typed in? Weird head woman or?
Lady with head.
Yeah. Weird people or something I put in.
Sure. Yeah. Did you come up?
Yeah. 7,000 hits, Carl Pilkington.
Well, it's all there, isn't it? It's interesting. The one that I was telling you before about, the lost letter.
The lost letter? What's
the lost postcard that's, just turned up. Some woman sent a postcard years and years ago to a niece or something, right? Yeah. And her niece was like 3 years old back then. And just now, like, I think like yesterday or the day before, the postcard turned up 74 years late.
74 years late?
It took 74 years.
And that 3-year-old girl's been living in the same house that whole time.
Well, that, yeah.
Sure.
You see what I mean? There's always a question you can ask to just scratch the credibility of these stories.
Yeah.
There's always, it's like the apocryphal tale.
Was this those slugs from last week?
Yeah, were they holding stealing? Back? Because they're slow, because the postman slug is useless. His round takes him 74 years. Then he's got to go back to the beginning, he's got 74 years, and they can't carry the bag. That's why they turn to glue.
Oh. It's pitiful.
It is pitiful.
So you don't believe that someone sent a postcard years ago and somehow it's been stuck in the bottom of a post bag or something and it's only just-
Stuck in the bottom of a post bag? Yeah. That means that there's like a 95-year-old postman who's still wandering around.
Did you have to pay, like, the difference and the charges? Because presumably
it wouldn't have had Queen Elizabeth's-
It was a penny black, presumably, was it?
Yeah. What would be on the stamp? It would have been invalid, surely.
Don't know.
See, these are the questions you should ask yourself.
Because if it's the postman's fault, The postman can't turn
out. Who was 83 at the time himself, wasn't he? He was the-
No, he is dead. Yeah, he'll be well and truly dead now.
Yeah.
But the fact is that the post office made an error, right? They lost this letter.
Sure. Mm.
It's only just turned up. They can't turn around and say, sorry about this, I hope it isn't urgent. It's turned up 74 years late, and by the way, you owe us 25 pence.
Yeah. Yeah.
They wouldn't do that, would
no,
they?
No, that's
so,
true, that's true.
So
that's true. You're asking questions, though, you see? That's true, you see? So, you're interested in, like, where sayings come from as well, aren't you? Because you told me one in the week, what that- I don't know if Steve's aware of that. Do you want to tell Steve this one?
What's this a saying?
Can we do this quiz?
Let's do the quiz later. I know you're excited about the quiz. Let's do that later, but what's this saying?
Right. What is the saying? Chucking a baby out with the bathwater.
Yeah.
Have you heard that phrase?
Don't throw the baby out with the bathwater.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, how would you use that?
Well, how would I use that? Don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. I suppose if maybe you've been discussing something, you've come up with some plans, but you're slightly worried and, you know, you might abandon the whole plan, whereas there might be some ideas in there which are still worth retaining.
Exactly.
So you don't want to throw the baby out with the bathwater.
There might be something you can just change and you don't really-
A similar, you know, there might be a few ideas you can salvage from an otherwise worthless one.
Well, the saying, right, comes from, like, years ago again.
Mm-hmm.
And,
pre or post phone?
And, ages and ages ago when, like, you know, the bloke worked in the house, you know, he was, like, the coal man. And then you had, like...
No way, it's important.
Then, like, the mum is, like, you know, she stays at home making the dinner, looking after the kids.
Yep.
Mm. And you've got, like, the little kid who's just growing up, just messing about and stuff. So, what happens is, back then they didn't have, like, fresh, flowing, warm water every day.
Mm.
So all they could do, they could only afford to have, like, one full big bath of fresh water. So they'd fill up the bath, right? And then the dad would come home and he'd say, oh, I've had a right, you know, I had a tough day at work and that, down the pit. And, his wife would say, it's all right, I'm putting the dinner on, you're gonna have a nice warm bath.
So, because he gets the bath first.
Because he gets the bath first, because he's the grafter.
And he's covered in coal.
He's covered in coal, so the water's, like, minging by the time he's finished.
Yeah.
Right? And then the wife says, oh, after all my, cleaning the house and doing the cooking, I'm a bit sweating out.
She's covered in dust and grime, she has next time.
I'll have a bath, right?
Yeah.
At the end of the line, there's a little baby.
Yeah, yeah.
He's been playing out all day. Also got, like, little grubby knees and stuff, needs to have a bath.
Yeah.
He goes in the bath. Right? But because the water is so dirty...
Sure.
They go and empty the water out of the window, can't see the baby in it, chucking the baby out with the bathwater. That's where it comes from.
I don't know what to say, Steve. Because I've heard this, I'm just...
What do you think, Steve?
So
firstly, that sort of, I mean... That doesn't explain
where do you
why-
start? Well, you're struggling, aren't you? You're struggling where to start.
Well, firstly, I can't see how we've now applied this to, the example
that I've
been
thinking of this for days, Steve, waiting for you to hear this one.
These coal mining parents, deeply negligent.
Yeah, I love
they've left their baby in the bath, unattended.
That's the way around to do it. The one covered in coal-
Yeah.
Has you go first.
Sure.
You go first. Don't wash the baby and then get in that.
Yeah.
Your one covered in coal goes first, that's the best idea.
Yeah.
Second most dirty one goes second, and then the clean little baby, I think we should do him last, because he's done nothing towards this family.
But more than that, Rick, leave him to his own devices.
Yeah.
Jack, I'm just gonna throw the water out.
Yeah.
In the bath.
Don't check first.
Have you checked that the baby's not in there?
No,
I'm not even gonna waste my time checking.
You'd see it.
I'd be able to see a baby.
You'd see a baby in there.
If a baby was in here, I'd be able to see it. I'm just gonna throw it out.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna look, to be honest, Jack. We've all had our bath.
Yeah.
If the baby's in there, then it should be making itself-
Be careful, Jack. We have lost three children this way. Don't worry. Where did you read that?
The acid. Right, tell the other story that you totally believe this as a true story, don't you? The fella with the being killed.
Right, do you know how the other week we were talking about some fella who had his head cut off and he said, when my head goes into the basket, I'm gonna blink a lot, see how many times I can blink.
But if you remember, when Carl first told me that, it was, I think it was Simon or, Nick that pointed out, he goes, no, that's not quite right, Carl. Carl told me it, that he had his head cut off, and when his head was in the basket, it looked up and said, count how many times I blinked.
Yeah,
but he believed that as well.
Yeah,
so he was happy with that.
Sure.
Do you know
sorry,
what I mean?
So yeah, you a couple of weeks ago, there was a guy, he had his head cut off, and before he had it off, he'd said, I'm gonna blink to show that there's life after death, and
he did 32 blinks,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, sure.
So, you two were sort of pointing that down the other week.
Yeah, we were skeptical.
So, I looked again
on the internet?
At some other website.
Mm. Yeah.
And there's a guy.
Sorry, is the website, just to clarify, the website is the place where you bought that property on the moon, didn't you? Because it was a bargain.
Right. So, this guy.
Fingers umped.
Look, we'll see who's been gazumped when this world ends. I've got somewhere to go, right? And I know you'll be calling me up, saying, oh, can I come with you?
Have you got, like, two square foot, though?
No, I've got acres.
You're gonna have to stand deadly still on the moon in your 2 square foot.
I've got about 20
acres. There's no place for Suzanne, it'll just be you.
12
off, love. It's all those people with big heads and web feet that have been buying it all these years.
Well, listen, right?
Go on.
Anyway.
Play a record, tell us a story after it. We've been chatting for so long.
Sorry, Carl, no, there's no record.
Play a tune, we'll come back with this. What's this, another ghost story?
Let's play one of my favourite songs of all time, because I'm going on holiday and getting into a lovely, serene move. Serene Sorrento is probably from that. It's Neil Young, After the Gold Rush.
Beautiful. Still to come, that competition as well, look forward to that. Carl's quiz.
Yeah. What an amazing track
beautiful
that is.
Yeah.
Neil Young,
Dynamite.
After the Gold Rush. So go on, Carl, sorry. Go on, Carl.
So just take us back a few steps, Carl. What's the story?
Right, so I did some research. Right.
Let's just recap again. The guy, there was a guy you read about who had his head chopped off, he was guillotined.
Yeah.
He had said to the people around him,
count
I am
blinks.
Going to blink once I've had my head cut off to
so
show
the brain
that life
can still.
Or the brain can continue to work after, death. Okay, so yeah, we queried that.
So you weren't having any of it?
Well, no, possibly for a few seconds till the oxygen stops being fed to the cells because the blood has drained away. But, you know, nothing spectacular. So
right,
go on.
Well, along the similar sort of lines, right? This is quite a few years ago. This fella sort of upset the royal family doing something, right? So they said that this isn't good.
It wasn't Ben Outland at that Jubilee thing, was it?
I can't remember what it was. And they said, right,
that was terrible.
We're gonna cut your head off. You know, you gotta show people like you can't be doing what you've been doing.
What was this? The 1970s?
When
you say a couple of years ago, you mean maybe sort of.
Was it the olden days when the phones weren't very good?
Ages ago.
Yeah.
Ages ago, sure.
So yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
So.
Very philosophical.
Yeah, imagine that. Yeah. You watching this
going right on.
This was literally ages ago.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, go
Simon Sharma's History of Britain.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, so, and even before that, which is yonks, before, when it was all mental and different. Sorry, Carl, go on.
So he's having his head cut off, and he's resigned to it.
It's a day before, he's kind of got it into his head now that I'm not going to have my head much longer.
Sure.
So he said, let's make use of this.
Yeah.
He said, I wonder how long, like, the body can stay alive without me head on it, right? So they were like, oh, I don't know. So,
Hoover.
So.
The jailers?
Whoever he was asking.
These jailers with one eye.
Yeah.
Get out, thug.
So he said,
no, wait a minute, I've got an interesting scientific experiment, jailer. Well, fair enough.
What is it?
So, he said, what I want to do, right? He said, you know, surely it's my last right. You know, I'm gonna be dead tomorrow.
Sure.
So let's
he
do
didn't
a test.
Draw it out this long, did he?
Yeah, he said let's test this out. You know, he said do us a favour. He said, you know, it's my last day. What I want you to do is you're gonna cut my head off. Let's put a white line on the floor.
Right.
And see if you know, because there's no point asking how far he can sort of walk without an head if there isn't a line, because you don't know what to count. Do you know what I mean? If it's just, if he loses his head and he's running around all over the place, you can't really count
that's
that.
Not impressive enough, yeah.
So they said, let's make a white line.
Sure,
yeah. Who said this? He did or they did?
I think they started to join in with him and say, well, let's make this a, you
sure. You guess it, go on.
So,
they got Norris McWhirter down. The Guinness people.
Oh.
Yeah.
So they said, let's get this white line.
Yeah.
And,
dedication's all he needs.
We'll do this tomorrow. And he said, all right, then, I'll see you in the morning.
Yeah. See you in the morning! I'll see you in the morning! Night, night, sleep tight. Bye-bye.
I love the fact that Carl knows exactly what was said.
Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah. He doesn't know the story or what order it's in or when
but
it
he
was.
He knows exactly what was said.
Or who says what, but he knows the intricacies. All right, then, see you in the morning. Bye-bye. Little kissy, kissy, kissy.
Oh, I'm not like that. Oh, you joker. Oh,
don't let the bed bugs bite.
Yeah. Anyway.
So he gets up.
Do you want a paper tomorrow?
No, I'm all right. Go on.
He gets up and they say, right, you know, today's the day and that. And he said, well, you know, I've got used to the idea. So here's a white line for you.
Got used to the idea. Go on.
So they go, right, are you ready then? And he said, I go on. And they cut his head off. And the body walked 32 steps without a head.
Wow.
32 steps.
Incredible.
And that's the lesson, really.
Did it get as far as the it walked along the white line, did it?
Yeah, it stayed along the white line, did 32 steps, and then started to stumble a bit, and it just fell over.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, it was a test that your body can still keep alive for a little bit.
Yeah.
When you've lost your head.
Absolute twaddle. Absolute twaddle.
What do you reckon you can do, then, without an head? How many steps?
Nothing. There'd be muscular spasm, right?
Yeah. It would twitch a bit.
It would, yeah. You could not distinctly take 32 steps.
Hmm.
The body well, don't.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah. Is the doctor still on the line?
Yeah.
The fellow that bought 6 parrots.
Yeah.
And, you know, you could have 32 steps.
Right, so you don't believe that.
I'm doing a bit of line dancing.
Right, you don't believe that, but something that you do believe that a cockroach can live a week without an head.
It can.
Hmm.
Slightly different. Slightly different kettle of fish there.
Why?
Well, insect to, human is what I'm thinking.
Yeah,
that difference.
There's not that much difference in some insects. Do you know that a snake has a heart and lungs and kidneys and stuff?
Go on.
No, well, I'm just saying.
So?
You're making out as if, like, they're a totally different, like,
species. I am making out. I mean, call
Rick,
me old-fashioned.
Do you know what you're talking about, though? I don't want you embarrassing yourself, Rick.
Yeah, I am suggesting they're totally different beings, yeah, that is, yeah. Now, Carl, the cockroach is very- You've got another hour of it. Have you got anything at all?
I've got that feature Educating Ricky, which is a bit of a play on words as well. Right. Do you know the film, Steve?
Educating Rita.
Yeah.
I see what you've done. Go on.
I'm doing that, and I teach Ricky stuff.
what do you teach me, Carl?
Well, I've got a few different topics.
Go on.
Do you know, like, how you taught me about Hitler and Che Guevara and Winston Churchill?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to come in with topics every week, and this week I've got,
ghosts?
No. Hanging bacon is one of the topics.
Say that again?
Hanging bacon.
Hanging bacon.
All the titles.
Francis Bacon.
No, all the titles are sort of named to sort of make, sort of tease you and get you more interested in it.
Hanging bacon? Well, you've certainly intrigued
me. Go on, what's another title one?
Hairy Chinese Kid.
Could I'm gonna go for that one.
If there was a university degree with that title.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna go for Hairy Chinese Kid,
and
I think.
The final one.
Yeah.
Alien Gives Man a Beard.
Alien gives man a beer.
I am gonna burst. Right, listen, Carl, you've gotta tell me. Right, let's do it in reverse.
No, we're not gonna do it now anyway.
What do you mean? We've got to do it now. I mean, this is the first interesting thing you've said in an hour. Okay, the listeners have just been subjected to rubbish and and mistakes and everything for the last 6 months. Please, we've got to do Alien Gives Man a Beard. What is that? Tell us that.
Right.
Sorry, this is just you telling me something, is it? Well, this feature is you telling me something.
Well, teaching you something. Educating Ricky.
Right. So, are we playing it now? We're already into this feature. Well into this feature, are we?
Yeah, I suppose we are, yeah.
Should there not be a jingle or something?
Yeah, can we have a jingle?
There's no point, because look, I come up with ideas and you dismiss them straight away, so I'm not wasting my time making stuff.
Right.
If you don't like
it. Let's play Educating Ricky.
Right.
Brilliant. Go. Right. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling.
Educating Ricky.
Right, what are we going for then? Hanging the bacon, airy Chinese kid, Alien Gives Man a Beard.
I think Alien Gives Man a Beard.
I'd like to do that.
Right, there's this fellow, I think it happened in America, and he saw a bright light in the sky. And,
God, if you're bored.
And he stood there.
This is a true story, is it?
Yeah. He stood there.
Yes, of course it isn't, Steve.
And he saw this bright light, and it came closer and closer, and it was a UFO, right?
Yep.
And he looked at it, and it disappeared, right? And he gets back in his car.
He looks in the mirror.
And he looks in the mirror.
Yep.
He's only got a beard.
He has.
No! You sure it wasn't someone else who got in the car, and he was still standing out there?
No, right.
What?
And it turned out,
yeah.
He got home and said to his wife or his girlfriend, it's a bit weird. So I just got out of the car to look at a bright light, and I got back in the car and I grew a beard, and she said, never mind your beard, where have you been for 3 days? And what had happened is...
He passed out because he was pissed.
No. The UFO had taken him for 3 days.
Yeah.
But he'd only thought that he'd only looked at it and it went away.
Yeah.
But what had happened is, he took him, and he grew a beard because he hasn't had a shave.
Right, okay. I mean,
Will Smith or Tommy Lee Jones anything to do with this at all? Did you see this on a video maybe and thought it was an educational film?
No, it's from a book that some kind person sent in to me. Here.
Can I just ask again, I'm just throwing this right back at you. Do you think there's any other possible answer here? Right, a man is absent for 3 days from home.
He's grown a beard.
The length of time that it could take to grow a beard, lest we forget. What if he hadn't actually seen a bright light in the sky?
What if he was lying? What if he was lying?
He'd got knocked unconscious, he'd had a car crash.
Just lying. No, just lying.
Or he was just lying.
Yeah, he'd been on a bender, getting pissed for three days
with his
mates.
And that was his excuse to his wife.
And they went, Dennis, what are you gonna tell your wife?
well,
wait a minute.
She's not gonna believe I was out with you, lads.
Just say you're on your way for a minute. No, she didn't know I wasn't away from it because of the beard. Oh yeah, look, it looks like you've been out for 3 days. Well, we have. That's
exactly.
Right. Okay, we've got to cover that then. alien abduction.
Great one.
Okay, let's try that.
Do you see? That's a little scenario there that could have been played.
So, when you say educating Ricky, what have I learnt from this? Never listen to you again. That's all I've learnt so far. Never listen to you.
Yeah, we'll add a little bit more in here, right?
To well, no. What do you mean, add a little bit more?
We'll add a bit more to this. To this, what I'm educating you about.
Go on.
Right. There's only a law in America that says if you touch a UFO, you're going to get done. Now, why would they make a rule? I don't know that. Do you know, like, all their rules have a carry-
Carl, I genuinely do not know what you're talking about.
Right. Do you know, like, how here-
Do you know what-
I have no idea.
Right.
Okay.
Do you know, like, over
Rick,
here-
I'm listening to Capital and these headphones. I got Foxy on from yesterday.
Right, let's bin that.
No, wait, it's crazy.
I want to hear about Airy Chinese Kid.
Let's play a tune.
Okay, play a tune. Go back to Airy Chinese Kid, definitely.
Some Doors.
Yeah, I just thought I'd go back, take it back to the 60s. This is a tune that a friend of mine sent
me. If you touch a UFO, you get done.
Soul Kitchen from the Doors.
Shambles today, this.
David Bowie, Slow Burn, yeah. Quite a Eno trilogy feel about it. Lodger and sort of low type, yeah. But, yeah.
Enjoyable.
Now, okay. That's stressful, isn't it? I think we've got things working now. We've had people coming in and out, just shaking their head, going, shouldn't have bought that desk. But it's all sorted now, I think. And,
About 25 minutes for them to come down as well, though. Do you feel like we're maybe quite low in the pecking order in the building?
Definitely.
You know, it's like Capital First, Capital Gold. They can shoot off to other sort of pirate stations.
Yeah.
People's car radios, then they come back here.
Oh, dear. Oh, I had a job at Richard Sounds.
yeah.
Light fitting was buzzing.
Yeah.
Now, but we've got, thanks for staying, listening. Right, okay, educating Ricky. What have we got? Airy Chinese Kid, go on.
Right, yeah. This is the, I didn't want to do this.
What really? Do you mean you didn't want
to do it? Well, I wanted to give you three and I gave you one. It was like the alien man gets a beard or whatever.
Yeah.
And
which was total rubbish, so this one should be better, maybe.
Hey, Chinese Kid. Right, well, yeah. We've talked about airy people in the past.
True enough.
Can't we?
Yeah.
You know, the little kids who grew up in woods and hung around with wolves and that.
Yeah, again, you're confusing it. Yeah, they're not, there were some people that were born very hirsute. They were not the people who were brought up with wolves. Yeah. You just put that together in your Homer Simpson type mind.
Right, well, this is like a sort of close to that sort of story.
Yeah.
but the weird thing is, right, Chinese people aren't that hairy as a nation. No, seriously, that's a well known fact.
They don't
have that much body hair and
right.
stuff.
Okay.
So this little kid who was born over there, he was like covered in stuff.
Was he?
And it was only his nose that wasn't hairy. The rest of his body was caked in hair, right?
Mm.
And his hair sort of
what grew. Sort of hair was it? Was
thick,
it
thick hair?
No, what I mean is, was it sort of like a pony's mane, so he just looked like an Ewok. You know what I mean? Just like hanging down, sort of straight, dark
hair. Looked, in the picture, it looked like it grows from
downy?
His eyebrow. It grows from his eyebrows quite thick, and then it just goes all the way over.
You
his
don't
head.
Think it was just really long eyebrows that he'd done a comb over?
No, it was all over his body. It had a picture of like his back and that.
Yeah.
And
had he styled it? Had he styled it at all? Did he have it a quiff or?
No, it was just
hanging
all
everywhere.
Over him.
Yeah.
And and they were like, you know, this is a bit weird, happening in China, where we're not normally that airy.
That was the scientist speaking there.
Yeah.
And the local press and that were getting him down, calling him monkey boy and all this.
Oh.
And,
thinking Chinese press.
But the doctor-
Yeah! Oh,
they're cruel, aren't they? The doctor- like those game shows. Well, that's Japanese, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's cool, though. Yeah.
And the doctor said,
I was still talking through all that time where we were just, like, talking to each other then. Because I turned round and I still saw he was talking.
Go on. So anyway, the local press came in to see the hairy boy, the monkey
boy. Yeah, and they were, like, being tight and taking the mickey out of him, and the doctor said,
driving him nuts.
Said, he's only hairy. Said, he's a healthy young kid. The only faults he's got is he's got a little bit of eczema and a boil. And he said everybody should just treat him the same, and I think he grew up a healthy kid. Yeah, so that's
the end of the story.
That's not a story.
Why?
Well, but I've got nothing. I don't know what to say to that. So someone in China was born slightly hairier than the rest, and he was normal apart from eczema and a boil. That to me isn't a story. But if it is, I've got a million. I mean, it's sort of like bloke from Manchester went a bit bolder than the rest, got a job on radio. He was normal. I mean, that's not a story, is it?
Some great adverts there on XFM. I enjoyed 0.9.
Absolutely. We have to give away these three pairs. We have to give these away, Rick.
Yeah.
We've got three pairs of DJ Shadows.
I know, but turn up with this is so jam-packed. I think we've planned too much for this show.
We have indeed.
I think we have a little bit flabbier next week.
Rick.
Do less.
Rick, can we chill out next week, please?
Yeah. Go on then.
So yeah, any ideas, guys? Any questions? Sort of DJ Shadow related questions? Any
Shadow.
Or DJ questions?
What
Carl, any ideas?
What does
then?
The word DJ mean?
Yeah, it's too easy. I'll tell you something I do know.
Go on.
Right. But I can't really get a question out of it.
Go on, just tell us.
There's a shadow somewhere.
It's already good, isn't it?
I'm loving it already.
No, right. There's a shadow, I think it was in America.
Yeah.
And it's on a quiet road. I'm guessing somewhere like Boston, that's what you imagine.
Okay. No.
Somewhere like Boston, and people at night used to see this shadow moving about, and they'd go, what's that? Right? And it got known, the town, the little local town got known for this shadow, but it didn't cause any problems.
People what are you talking about?
You've lost me.
What are you talking about?
No, do you know, like, some places get famous, like, Scotland's got the Loch Ness Monster and that, but it doesn't cause any problems.
It doesn't exist, go on.
Right? So there's this shadow walking about on the road.
And, rubbish.
Right, so it's
nonsense.
Walking about,
where did you read this? Where did you see
walking
this?
About, this was on the internet, and I'm
oh,
sure.
Sorry! Sorry! Right. I thought it was shite. I didn't know it was on the internet.
Right, so this shadow is moving about, and,
independently of an object.
Yeah, and the local mayor and that is like, yeah, it's a bit weird, but it's not harming anyone.
The mayor involved!
Was he elected to that post?
Hey, mayor, we got a problem down here, seems like a shadow. it's not causing anybody- No, it's just-
It's causing any problems?
Yeah,
But that's the thing, it was left for years, and then it did start causing problems.
I see, that's it. If you leave these shadows to go unchecked, Rick, they go crazy.
Yeah.
You let them run amok in the sea.
Yeah.
You've got to stab
them on
Roman shadows.
What did the shadow do?
It was pushing people off the bike.
It was what?
It was pushing people off the bikes.
Oh,
I'll find out more for that next week. Right, that'll tease
them. Oh, you're a maniac!
We'll do more on that. We haven't had time for education.
Please never have children.
Right, listen.
Just promise me now you'll never have kids.
No, we haven't got time.
Okay, listen, alright, DJ Shadow, have we got time to give these tickets away?
Yeah, if they just call up, we'll,
No, I'll tell you what, I've got a question, right?
Go on.
Where do you where does Carl think this may have taken place? If you've been listening to the show, where do you think this evil shadow has been running amok? Let us know. The number, Carl?
Good question. 08-700-800-1234. So, but that's it. We are actually out of time.
We are indeed. Now. Have I got time for a song for the ladies?
It's a bit tight. I was told to finish now.
Too.
I know, but we've got to get finished early today, so.
Why?
Just because we have, and we're wasting more time talking about why we have to.
Oh, this is pathetic.
So, they call up. Where did they see the ghost?
Yeah.
And you've got to pick the tickets up from reception. You can go tonight, see DJ Shadow.
Shoddy,
that's it.
This is shoddy.
Right, see you then. Lobe of this.
Yeah, get a lobe of this, yeah.
Well, that's a story about a girl who, she was deaf, right, for 4 years. And, it happened quite a bit back this.
What year?
Quite a bit back. She was deaf for about 4 years. Having an argument with her mum, it said, which I didn't quite understand. Because I don't know. how they do that.
Yeah.
But she was having an argument,
well,
and a man pushed her against the wall,
yeah,
and she banged her head, and a hearing came back.
Okay.
Was she wearing a Walkman, and it fell out, and she'd realised, oh, that's
there's
why.
No explanation.
There's no explanation? Well, why is that teaching me something,
right,
then?
So I knew you'd say this, right? So I thought, right, I'll stick something on it. Do you know that bees are deaf?
No! No, you can't just- no! If no. you ask someone something they don't know the answer to, they don't tell you something else. Just, I'll tell you something else then. I can't answer that, I'll tell you something else. Imagine that. If you asked a teacher. Look. How do birds fly? Wow, if you're gonna do that, tallest building is- I mean, what-
Well,
that was the equivalent, Carl, of running away when we asked you a question.
Yeah, the intellectual equivalent. Look, look over there, there's a monster.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen. What do you mean? What she? Okay, so. Oh,
so she. Her
there's
hearing.
No
came
explanation.
Back.
There's no explanation. There's or no. You don't know.
Well, there isn't one. This really.
What?
Did
the only thing. Doctors not look into it.
No, I think they just said, "Oh, that's good."
But, so again, I don't. Where did this information? Is that? If you read this on
is
the net,
it?
Is that all they put
there
on the net?
There was once no. a deaf woman who hit her head. And she
and
could
her
hear.
Came back.
It was bizarre things about being deaf.
Was there three?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Was there?
I've got that book. Yeah, it's a good book. That
was there. Three
yeah.
more pages. You just couldn't be bothered to read on.
Yeah.
No, no. It was just a little bit. And it
was there a little picture, a cartoon picture?
No pictures. I just read
going,
it.
Ow!
Look,
ow,
if you
I
don't
want to
know, if you don't want to learn, you know.
Yeah. Okay, okay, it's not his vault. Let me have it's not his vault. You've got to save this. This has got to teach me something. It'll be an interesting story.
Right, it's not his vault. This fella,
yeah. What year? Ages
olden
ago?
Times?
In, I'd say in the 70s.
Okay.
Would you? Any evidence for that?
And,
does he wear flares in the, in the story?
Right.
Is that your reason?
No, it's a bit like Yuri Geller, this fella, right? Where,
oh.
He's electric.
He's electric.
And, if he walks past the telly would fizz.
Uh-huh.
If he walked past the radio, it all goes like that.
Ooh.
His hair stuck up all the time.
Ugh.
And he'd be having a bath and everything would be alright and then the power would sort of switch on in his body and the electric in his body made him jump out of the bath. So.
What do you mean so? What is that so? What does that so mean? You've given us nothing. You've given us nothing.
You'd have to at least give us the scientific explanation.
Yeah.
Electric eels have 400 volts in them.
Oh, is this the running away again?
What was that one called?
Yeah, but they but
it's
there's-
it's not his vault.
But there's a reason that
not his vault, it's not his vault.
I thought it was gonna be something about keeping it safe.
I think we should do these the other way around.
It's
I think
not
you should tell
vault.
Us the story and then we'll hear the pun.
It's not his fault. It's not his fault.
Right, let's leave it.
Play a tune.
Forget it.
Educating Ricky.
We're not doing it.
No, we are. Oh.
I'll tell you what, though. Talking about ghosts and that. Do you know how I'm into them?
Yeah.
Right. How weird do you think this is? Right.
Well, it's not true. Before you say it, play a record.
No, go on, go on.
go on.
Right. It's this woman. I don't even know if it's ghost really. It's just a bit weird.
Sure. Yeah. Right? Sure.
There's this woman,
yeah.
And she's, well, she's not a woman, she's a kid.
Sure.
Okay.
She's walking down, like, a street in her area, it's a nice day and everything, everything's normal. She's walking down, and a woman comes up, cycling past, right? The woman on the bike looks at the kid, absolutely terrified, right?
Right.
Got a really scary face on her.
Yeah.
The kid's thinking, why is she doing that,
yeah.
Right? So anyway, she thinks nothing of it, goes... You know, I think she was playing in the park or whatever, goes and has a nice day. About 15 years later...
Oh, right, yeah.
She's... I don't know, I think she was going to work, right, on a bike.
She's riding her own bike.
Riding okay. her own bike. Cycling down the road.
Oh, yeah.
Looks at the kid. That's the thing that happened, like, 15, 20 years ago.
Right.
It's her on the bike looking at her as a kid.
Right. Not another child.
No. So right. It's her, she's seen herself.
Well, Carl... I mean, I don't know where to start.
Firstly, where does this information come from?
But I mean, why do you ever I mean, I don't know what part of that you think can be true. I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. What are you talking about?
Bit weird, though, isn't it?
But it's not true.
It didn't happen. Nothing happened like that.
She said it did.
Well, she's wrong.
She said she saw herself.
she saw herself as a kid, didn't she?
Did she carry
and
on writing
and
puff?
As an adult when she was a kid?
Did she stop and talk to herself, or did she ride on by and think, that's a bit weird, there's me as an 8-year-old. I won't stop, I'll be late for work.
Yeah. If I'm late again, the boss said he'd be in trouble. Yeah.
And where is this information? Was it, did it happen to someone you know?
No.
You overheard it on the bus?
No, it was in, it's in the 14 times.
Ah, right. Well, okay. That's the answer. Good. We've got to the bottom of that.
Right, good. Brilliant.
Now, what do you make of David Blunkett accusing-
That was the main bit of the story, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But this one, right, we have sort of talked about it, and, you weren't having any of it at the time.
What?
This next bit of science I'm telling you about.
Go on, then.
Right. Remember when I told you about a lad? He was living at home with his mum and dad, right? Everything's, you know, normal life, go to school, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Then, I think his mum and dad had an argument, and it kicked off a bit, and he thought, I'm sick of this. It's happening all the time now, they kept having arguments, so the kid ran off into the woods.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yep.
Right?
God.
Now, he left, he went and ran in the woods, and he ended up living with some monkeys.
Right.
Right? And he thought, this isn't a bad life, you know, there's no arguments going on.
Sure.
He was getting on with them, and the weird thing
is- He loved
bananas. This is where the science bit comes in.
Oh, sure.
He grew a load of hair on his body.
That's not true. It's not true.
It is true.
It's an acquired characteristic.
I bet someone will back me up on this.
But no, you can't grow hair like that. You might get a little bit, more down here, they might- the erectile tissue might, you know, they won't fall out as much that would, you know, but- You don't actually grow a big mane if you're cold and you're a human.
Well, he did. He did. This lad did. I know it sounds a bit strange in that, but he was living with the monkeys, and because it was cold, his body reacted
to it. Listen. He was no hairier than he would have been if he was walking around naked on a cold day, with or without living with monkeys.
The fact that he was living with monkeys makes no difference.
No, I know, but I'm trying to get, you know, picture it in your head what it's like.
Although Mickey Dolenz was always pretty hairy.
Right? So, he was living with them, and, he went into town or something one day.
Oh, yeah.
To get some food. And the people there were like, hang on a minute, that isn't a monkey.
Mm. He went in naked?
No, he was there covered in hair.
Yeah. Yeah, but naked, but covered in hair, so it was decent. It was.
Yeah. But that was a weird thing. They thought it was a monkey in the shop. And then
so presumably he had a big long beard as well, because he couldn't shave, could he?
No, he was just covered. He looked like a monkey.
And they were happy to serve the monkey, were they? There's a monkey. He's buying a newspaper and some milk.
How did he walk, Carl? Did he walk upright or whistling along?
The picture that I saw on the internet, he was on all fours, but I don't know if that's when he was running away after he'd sort of, you know, realised he was a kid. But this was a picture.
So he was a kid as well? He wasn't even like an adult with the beard?
No, he was a kid.
Brilliant. Brilliant. And the beard kicked in a little bit.
So listen, so the people caught him.
You're an idiot.
The people caught him, shaved him, right? Got it all off, didn't grow back again.
Right.
You're an idiot. Well, like I say, people will have heard this story or read about it.
You're an idiot.
And they'll email in, they don't let me down.
And they'll agree that you're an idiot.
No, they'll have seen the story.
You're an idiot.
So that's a little bit of science.
You're an idiot.
The weird thing is, right, looking around in the week at weird stuff on the internet, there's this woman who's got a big head.
Oh, yeah.
And, she was fed up with it because when she was walking down the street, it was so big, she couldn't hold it up.
Right.
Right?
She couldn't hold it up.
Oh, God.
Okay, shut up.
So, when she was walking, her eyes were hurting because she had to sort of look up all the time because her head was that heavy, her chin was sort of balanced on her chest.
Right. Right? And she'd have to peek up, yeah.
So, she goes to the doctors, and this was after years and years, and, said, you know, I thought I could put up with it, but I can't.
How big was her head?
It's big, Rich.
I don't know if it was, like, big, because there wasn't a picture. I don't know if it was just big or a lot of bone. So it was heavy.
Pretty heavy.
Right, like the elephant man, just
so,
outcrops.
Yeah, right? So, yeah. So the doctor said, yeah, we can sort that out. Mm-hmm. But we'll have to take your head off.
Right.
Okay,
listen, keep going.
Okay,
listen,
keep going.
Because what you don't seem to understand is I have the same reaction to you when I see it.
Yeah. What? Right? You're quizzical yourself.
So I looked at it, they took her head off, chipped away a bit of the bone,
mm-hmm.
made her head lighter, put it back on.
Right. Right, play the Smiths.
He took a woman's head off.
Yeah, this is Ask by the Smiths.
And if you'd like to ask Carl something, details coming up soon. How's that?
Got a couple of things under the banner of, colon then educate me.
Yeah.
We've got, this is interesting. Right. Do you know if you have, an operation on your brain, right, what they do is, I mean, this is why I'd never go to the doctors. I don't like doctors because this sort of stuff freaks me out, right? They can operate on your brain, and what they do is they put you to sleep first, cut your brain case open.
Your skull, yeah.
The brain case.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then wake you up and operate on you. So you sat there with your head open.
Yeah.
Messing with your brain, and you don't feel anything.
Well, there's no nerve endings, is there, in the brain?
But still, it's not right, is it?
Is it? What, you think they do it for fun?
No,
they
but-
go on, Reg, wake him up so he looks freaked out.
Is it necessary that you're awake, do you think, or-
Well, they need the brain active, don't they?
Yeah, but it is. When you're asleep, you're having mad dreams. I had a mad dream the other day.
Go on.
No, I might tell you about it later, but there's no sense to it. But, so your brain still, your brain still-
Where is this conversation?
Yeah, I mean, it'll turn out. I go, no, Carl, I was there, that wasn't a dream.
Yeah.
No, but, so, I mean, if I had an operation-
On your brain, heaven forbid.
Well, operation anywhere, I'd like to sort of think, well, I'll have an injection, I'll go asleep, but when I wake up, it'll all be sorted.
Yeah.
The fact that-
Your brain case is open.
Open, and they wake you up and you think, oh, is it all done? And they say, well, have a look in the mirror. And your brain-
See, I don't think they do that. I don't think they try and frighten you when you're doing an operation.
Yeah, I don't think that you go about your business and they sort of follow you around, dabbling.
Yeah.
No, but it's almost like they are having a bit of a laugh with you.
Right, well, I'd just like to say now that they don't. Anyone who's going in for an operation on their head, do not ever listen to anything Carl says.
Why have you got to be awake? Because you'll be bored anyway, you'll be sat there.
Well, they give you a telephone directory, look, and they say, look how many Macs are in there. That's the Scottish telephone directory. And, you know, time flies when you're counting that sort of thing.
No, but do you know, like, when you-
What are you telling me? What are you asking me?
I'm just saying how weird it is. It's weird, isn't it? It's like, do you know when you go for a haircut, right? It's a bit embarrassing. Well, I don't anymore, but when you go for a haircut, it used to be a It used to be a bit embarrassing when, like, they'd wet your hair and they'd make you have that sort of- Hitler cut because your hair's wet, and I used to hate it. And I think, do you have to do that? Do you know what I mean? You know
it's
what I mean?
Similar, it's very similar to open skull surgery.
What I'm saying is, it's almost like barbers like to do that to make you look daft and feel daft for a bit. And there's women coming in and out, and you're sat there with a daft haircut.
Yeah.
And this is what that reminds me of.
Do you think that? Do you think they do it in a shop window? This brain operation?
I'm just saying, it's a bit weird.
Why are we doing it in John Lewis's? Just so more people
I love the idea that that's what doctors are doing. Let's make this guy look a bit stupid.
Yeah.
Open his brain
look
case.
Look at the twatty look for this brain out of his head.
Take a Polaroid. Reg,
take a Polaroid. Look at him. Look at his face. Right, clock his face when I give him the mirror. Get this on camera.
Put this fake nose and glasses on.
Sorry, did you teach me something then? Was that educational?
I taught you that your brain case can be open with your awake. And you just sat there sort of letting him get on with it.
Brilliant, I've learned that. I'll never forget that. Right, go on, anything else?
You'll love. Let's play a song, because the next one is amazing.
What, even more amazing than that?
Yeah. Play a song?
Yeah, bit of Bowie?
No email still, by the way.
No, I don't think it's working.
It's not working
today,
so we'll have to do a phone-in for Rockbusters.
Off the Ziggy Stardust album.
Alright. Old woman, about 70 years old.
Yeah.
She's normally fit and healthy and stuff, nothing wrong with her, she's having a good life. And, one day, she goes for a check to the doctors, just to check herself out, because she's getting on a bit.
Yeah.
Says, take your clothes off and that. So, she does. And, checks her out, says, yeah, you're looking good. Turn round. He said, oh, God. He says, you got a tumour on your buttock. Right? So, she goes, oh, what, can you do anything to sort it out? So, they go, yeah, we'll book you in for an operation, it's best if we remove this. Books are in for an operation. Operation day comes, strip her down and that, they're all stood round, the doctors, start to operate. It only turns out it's a pork chop that she sat on 5 years earlier and it had stuck to her buttock.
Right, Carl.
Listen,
Carl, I'm telling you now, I'm leaving. I'm never doing this show again.
No, I'm serious, honestly.
You're talking, I've never had such You are. Play a record. Play a record.
I can't believe it.
What do you mean you can't believe it? Stop the record. Stop the record. Stop the record. Right, okay. Right, what do you mean you couldn't believe it?
No, when I read it, I said, I've got to tell Richard.
This woman had a pork chop stuck to her ass for 5 years, you mental case. Of course she didn't.
I don't think I did answer it. I just said, you know, the odd thing.
You just said, I'm asleep.
Little things like, I ran home the other night and said, oh, I've just learnt something today. She goes, go on. And, you know Lego bricks?
Oh, yeah.
The name came about, cos some kid's mum, the kid was messing with the bricks, and she said, Lego of them and come and have your dinner.
Play a record.
It's gotta be rubbish. It's got to be rubbish.
It's always rubbish, isn't it?
They're Scandinavian for a start, so...
It's Scandinavian.
Well, there's no... Lego.
Interesting. Thanks for that.
Whereas Lego was, yes, invented when a mother had sent someone to get some, though there's no name for them, she went, can you go and get some? There was a gap, he went, yeah. Oh yeah, I'll go and get some, cos they weren't called anything, brought them back, started playing with her. And then she went, look, give me those. He went, no, she went, Lego, you idiot.
Yeah, the actual explanation, various people have emailed us in or phoned in now. The company was set up in 1934, it's a Danish company, obviously.
Yeah.
Lego comes from the Danish words leg got, which means play well, and it was later discovered that it was also a Latin phrase that meant I study or I put together.
Yeah. Didn't they?
I mean, whatever, do you know what I mean?
Why, what's the matter with you? What's the matter with you today?
I'm just saying, I'm just-
What, you're fed up with people, taking issue with some of the stupid things you say? Lego was invented by a mother going, Lego of that. What are we gonna do with all the buildings? The earth might collapse. What do you expect people to say? Well, even our listeners know you're talking rubbish. And some of those aren't allowed to wear socks. I mean...
Listen, right, last week-
Got an idea, I can see it in your eyes. He's got a brilliant idea. Wait for it, go on.
No, no. It's something, when I was looking on the web, found something out.
Go on.
It's a story about a woman who had a baby, who had a baby.
What are you talking about? What?
A woman who had a baby who was having a baby.
It was no clearer when you repeated it.
No! Go! I don't know what to do! I don't know what to do for the common good, right? Pursue this line of inquiry, right? Because I don't know where it's going, or play a record. I'm actually torn. I don't know what to do.
No, I remember seeing it and thinking, I've got to tell Ricky about that. It's brilliant.
What should we do? Should we go with it? It's entering into the abyss. It's opening Pandora's box. It's peeking. It's going down to the cellar.
I've got a couple of questions though.
Go on then.
Well, come down there with me.
Okay,
come down the cellar with me.
Okay, right, Carl. What, first of all, it was on the way, what do you mean? The baby was what? Had another, was it, she didn't give birth, the doctor didn't find one of those set of Chinese dolls up her? Russians dolls, whatever they're called.
That's what I pictured it like, those dolls where you take the head off and there's another one in there that all look the same, but no, the story was, there's a woman who's-
No, don't just say it again, that's a headline, that's not a story. There was a woman who had a baby, who had a baby. Yeah. That's not a story. That, imagine handing that in as a thesis to loads of the BMA. There you go, and read that.
That's a children's rhyme.
Yeah, there was a woman who had a baby, who had a baby. What do you mean? So the baby, she had a baby, right? Yeah.
And,
That bit's fine, we're okay with
that's
that.
That's normal, that's normal.
A woman had a child.
Yeah, totally normal.
She gave birth, fine.
Yeah.
Next.
Well, I don't know that much more, apart from the fact that the baby's, like, roaming about, and then, 12 months later, she's like, oh.
Interesting, so the gestation period of that baby was actually 3 months more than an adult.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Weird, though, isn't it?
So, was the headline, my baby's 12 months pregnant? What are you talking about, 12 months later, it had a, what are you talking about?
Forget it.
No, you haven't even finished the story. That you said, and 12 months later, you didn't even finish the sentence. So what do you mean?
No, I didn't read any more into it because I just saw
you
that
didn't
and I thought,
what?
That's weird. And then I just was thinking, oh, like, imagine the kid at school, at parents' evening.
Go on.
And it's like, well, your kid's pretty good. Now let's have a look at your work sort of thing. Don't you think that'd be weird?
But what? Did the child have a baby?
Yeah.
Because it didn't! Play record!
We shouldn't have gone down in the cellar. We should have just left the cellar door closed.
I never learned.
Monkey's Pleasant Valley Sunday, brilliant. XFM 104.9, Carl Pilkington.
This show is monkey heavy, isn't it? It is monkey heavy. Carl, if you were president, would you sort of make it compulsory to maybe have a little monkey? Everyone has a little monkey of their own. Little chimps out and out, old age pensioners.
It's not a bad little, it's funny, you know, because there was, a story the other day, when I was looking for monkey news. Yeah. There's a story about a couple who couldn't have any kids, right? There's something wrong with them, but they really wanted a kid. And they got some, dodgy email address where they could buy a baby online, right? It was someone who would have a kid and you could buy it for $3,000 or something, right? Yeah. So anyway, they got one, they got picked and like, brilliant, there's the money. Got the baby and everything, they were loving it. You know, playing with it and stuff. As it got older.
Feeding it.
It got area.
Oh, shut the f- oh, Carl.
Turned out they've been sold a chimp.
You maniac. You stupid mank twat. Talk shit. That is as if.
what? Didn't know it.
Oh, don't talk. Are you mental? You stupid.
Didn't make it into monkey news.
I know. Yeah.
It's a bit sad though. We don't like to bring the feature down.
Yeah. But and how long was this into? It got area. They're born hairy. They're not born like humans. Then develop hair because they go. Hold on. We better get the chimp stuff kicking in now because we're in the jungle.
School photograph. They were like, hang on a minute. It looks a bit weird.
Oh, you are just the rubbish. Mad, isn't it? Mad, isn't it? Mad, isn't it? Imagine, oh God, anyway. Just imagine if he was in charge, we did put him in charge of the country.
Go on.
Talking about this the other day.
Yeah.
oh, what was it now? listen, a fella,
no,
listen. All right,
he's got it now.
Go on.
This fella goes to the doctors, right?
Oh, right, okay. Right, if this isn't any way apocryphal, stupid, illogical, impossible, right, you are never, ever speaking again on radio. So make sure this is at least possible. I'll tell you what, I'll even give you improbable, but possible. So if anything that breaks the laws of the universe or logic, okay, that's all you have to avoid. On you go.
Right, so this fella, right, he goes to the doctors because he's got earache.
Right, okay, if a chimp's living in his brain, that he
go
gives,
on.
Go on.
So he's got earache, he's sat in the waiting room and it's all, his ears all bunged up and it's hurting a lot and what have you. So the doctor comes out and he goes, right, and because his ears all bunged up, he doesn't hear it that well, right? So he thinks it must have been me, right? So he wanders in.
Keep going.
Anyway,
I'm gonna hate this. I can just feel it in my bones. Steve, I'm gonna let you take over. Okay,
let's hear it. Come
so
on.
The doctor says, sit yourself down there, right? So he sits himself down. He goes, right, take your pants off, right? So he's thinking that's a bit odd. Anyway. Apparently he took his tackle off. The doctor, like, did some operation.
What, there in the waiting room?
No, in his office.
In his office, yeah.
What?
So he removed what? His genitals?
Yeah.
In his office?
Why, Carl?
Because he hadn't called him in.
Oh, he'd called in the bloke who wanted his testicles taken off, and he didn't hear it.
What?
So the doctor went out and said, Mr. Jones, who's here to me to whip off your cock and balls, just here and now, right? Bloke comes in, didn't it? It must have been me. So the bloke with the, who wanted his balls taken off didn't say, oh, I think he said me. So he didn't interrupt then. So the bloke goes in, he starts taking his testicles off and he doesn't say, I'm here for me ears.
Down. New Year's Eve, I taught him something, right, about, dead people.
No. You know, the things that taught me, I was saying, you're talking shite. He says they found out your soul weighs an ounce.
Your soul?
Yeah. Your soul weighs an ounce.
Right, who found this out?
I read it.
Your arsehole weighs an ounce.
Yeah.
There's no such thing. A soul weighs an ounce. You're talking to devil.
Alright.
Have you got any monkey news?
So what did they do? They weighed someone who was alive, and they will wait for you to die, then weigh you again.
There was someone.
You've lost an ounce. Yeah, I'm sorry, it must be your soul shooting off to heaven.
It was someone who was really ill, and they said, we can't do anything for you here, but we've got a bit of a idea that we want to do. Stuck him on some scales. He said, right, you weigh 9 pounds and an ounce, whatever, because he was wasting away. He died. 9 pounds. Right?
Fine, well, that's proof if proof we needed.
Talking shite.
Monkey news. We might as well leave it.
No, come on,
no, come on, tell monkey news.
No, it's nothing that great, really.
Is it worth playing the jingle? Quickly?
Go on, then.
Oh, chimpanzee that, monkey news!
Right, it's about a monkey.
2004.
It's about this woman monkey who was born in 1834. Right? Half monkey, half woman.
No. Not true.
It happened, apparently. It was in the Daily Mail. Right?
Okay.
The Victorian Ape Woman was her name.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I christened this, thing, Victorian Ape Woman. Well, we thought Sandra. No! I'm calling it Victorian Ape Woman.
She was about 4 foot.
No, didn't happen.
She had lovely thick black hair on her head, and on the back of her legs, and her arms.
Yeah.
Alright.
So, stockings.
Let's have a look.
And she didn't need a bustle because of her huge ape-like arse sticking out the back of her dress.
She was good at reading and sewing.
Good, because they didn't have opposable thumbs, so,
She could speak three languages.
Yes.
She was
human, monkey, and monkey-human.
20 offers of marriage. Does that annoy you, Steve?
absolute twaddle.
All right, well,
that's more rubbish than your soul weighing an ounce.
Let's leave
a Victorian
it there.
Monkey
let's
woman.
Leave it there, then.
See you next week with some more twaddle.
I was worried we wouldn't have the old magic in 2004, but we're still talking shit. Merry New Year.
Bollocks.